Yeah, sicko.
No, it's literally called Roundup.
You know...
Oh my goodness. So I posted on the Ask Reddit, what's the craziest breakup story you've experienced or heard about? Someone writes, drunk in a hotel room, I planted a flower in her bare bum from the vase on the nightstand. She said she did not like it and left. I've heard of the flower in the bum thing, but why do people do that? His response, it has to do with the consuming way too much alcohol and having a 400-pound naked woman on your bed. Bad decision, basically.
Hallelujah.
A breakup due to incorrectly cooked pasta.
This pasta is stringy. I'm leaving you.
My friend had to break up with someone she didn't know she was dating. Cheating stories. Oh, wow. This is one that's kind of weird. My recent ex-boyfriend, who was secretly sleeping with a 15-year-old girl, he claimed she was just a friend. I was waiting for this.
You're not.
Yeah, but I need.
Hey,
she
guys.
Lied to me about her age. Not sure if he knew her real age or not. I suspected something was off, but didn't figure out until I moved in with him, and a month later he moved her in without a word to me. Story short.
Here's a little rule of thumb. About. Well, I mean, this guy gets it. What I was going to say was, most of the stories on Reddit, probably false.
Yeah, but I like reading them anyway.
I would sub-story some Reddit.
I've, for about 3 minutes, I have also been muted for most of that time, because I'm an idiot.
So we're all just an idiot. We all probably sound like lunatics. Like, who is
who's this other guy they're talking to? The fucking guy that's running the stream, of course. Hey, and welcome to the pre-show for MVGDead's Trivia Murder Party. We're going to play some more Trivia Murder Party here in a little bit. Dane, Michelle, and Adam are on the call with me at the moment. More will probably show up. We had Adam Bednarczyk, that is. Obviously not Adam Winkleman. Adam Winkleman does not sound Australian in the slightest.
Well, I mean, he can try, but he sucks.
Although, Bednarczyk sounds Australian in the slightest, but... It's true, though. You're the least Australian-sounding person I've ever met. From Australia, that
is. About time.
I mean, obviously, like I could say Dane's the least Australian-sounding person I ever met, because he's from fucking New York.
A fucking piece of shit.
Excuse me, I think me living with my neighbors, the deer... and the bears in the middle of nowhere.
You gotta get some better farm teams out there, notice. The deer and the bears, really? That's the only two teams that ever play there.
The deer.
The koalas and the schmuck.
The koalas and the mar. The
what?
Sports team known as koalas in Australia.
The Toowoomba marmosets. That's a real place in Australia. Look it up.
I'm looking for
that exists.
Lard cats winning the World Series.
Did you say the lard cats?
Yes.
The lard cats.
Like, yeah. Lord Cat, like fucking Jason Polaris winning the World Series by himself.
Granddad.
He probably could beat the Cubs by himself.
Granddad.
I'm looking forward to the Tallulah Bankheads winning the Grand World Series.
Guys, don't know if you know this, but you know the actor Michael Macy?
Yeah, he owns the fucking the store. Macy.
No, not that guy, but he's an actor who recently passed away, and now he's known as the actor who accidentally killed Brandon Lee doing a set of the Crow.
You know, that's got to be a stigma.
That is that probably stuck with him through his entire life. I accidentally killed Brandon Lee.
I would say so. It's like,
oh no, I killed Bruce Lee's son.
You know, I did Shakespeare. I did Barefoot in the Park. Hey, you're the guy that killed Brandon Lee.
Oh, no, I just owned the farm team out in Tallahassee, the Tallahassee Gaganch Farts.
That's kind of a bad sign. I mean,
whoa.
The Tallahassee. Yes, I acted everything.
The Tallahassee Gaganch Farts.
I killed Brandon Lee.
Folded in 1967. Kind of
thing, you know? No, look, I mean, because they fired up the Gaganch.
Hey.
Second.
Hey, Flossie.
Now, 10 out of 10 best thing ever.
What was that thing that we called Winkleman on
it's like come something or other. I don't fucking remember it. Hold on.
You guys have called me so many
No, things. It was a question on Quiplash. It came up. It said the rejected name for Winkleman, and I don't fucking remember. Let me scrub through the goddamn thing here and find out.
Oh, it was when I was playing. I do. Because
I still have that. No, this was last night.
You know, the question came up on Quiplash.
Hold on, I'm trying to find it.
Say something that False Man said to Dane at 3 in the morning.
No. Here, I found the actual.
Oh, no.
Hold on, I found the screen cap. I'll screen cap it.
Okay.
I'll screen cap it and send it to you in the Discord here. Because this is too good not to pass up.
Michelle, say hello to me.
There's the snapshot
hello to
right
me.
There.
Something said by. Oh no! That was last week.
No, this was last night, dude.
This is something else. We're talking about the come thing.
You were not there. You were not there last night, Adam. Don't even try to lie that you weren't.
This screenshot. Because I know that we did. Fucking copied my answer.
These are two legit quotes.
Did I wake you up?
These are two legit quotes said to me by Mr. Winkleman.
Alright, the one we're looking for is in. I think it's in the other one. Let me find it. The one that's right, like, the name that Flossie rejected before going with Flossie.
Yeah.
Let me find it.
Yeah, because I know that with Quiplash, for Quiplash with the extra, you guys, that was...
There it is! I found it!
Yeah. Oh, no.
I found it. Now I'm going to save it, and I'm going to put it in the thing.
Because, Mike, you stole, like, the actual answer.
There it is. Here we go. Enjoy.
Wink man or Cum-yumpa!
Cum-yumpa! Oh, I'm sounding like a cartoon character at this point.
I am the Cum-yumpa!
I'm gonna put this one up on the stream for a second, because I feel it's too good not to share.
Here's here's the fucking jackpot, the Cum-yumper.
It's
your name?
There's
your
the screen.
If not Cum Yarper, I will be sorely disappointed.
I'm surprised.
There it is from last night.
And yes, yes, Michelle is going to be Cum Yarper now.
Thank you.
You're welcome. I love you.
You don't love her. You love me.
Yes, I
you
love
get
you.
Your shit straight.
Hey, I like you, Michelle.
Oh. You know, last night when
I write about you in my middle school notebook.
Hey, what? You know, you told me that you would give me a tub bath.
There we go. I cropped it down to just.
I didn't say whose cum it would be.
I cropped it down on the stream to just the cum yarper answer.
thank you, Mike.
You're
I
welcome.
Love you dearly.
Just keep it right there on the overlay for a while.
I am straight. You're the homo.
You're the
homo.
You're the home.
By the way, there's the room code. Dane reposted it in the Discord for those of us the Discord.
I think you're the homos is probably deeper than Chris Chan could ever hope to achieve.
Hey, hey, hey.
You're the homo. I'm bi.
You're the homos. For those of you who are not up to date on your Chris Chan.
I'm feeling a little.
Those of you not up to date on your Chris Chan lore, he farts out his gaganch.
I hope you're doing that, but I'm feeling a little sick right now.
Here's the thing.
I can't make any videos.
Wait, Dane.
Winkleman, slow down, my boy.
No. That was genuinely an excuse. He had a cold.
Oh.
And he put up a video where he, like, I'm feeling a little sick. Like, I can't. I won't be able to fulfill any video requests. Like, he forgot that he was trying to be sick halfway through it.
He gave up.
Yeah, he gave up, and then he's like, I can't do any video requests. Like, when a motherfucker is so lazy that when Weens pay him $50 to do, like, a video... Like a 1 minute or a 30 second or 1 minute video. I wish I could do that because I would.
Well, see,
I would be making videos fucking left and right. It would just be, hey, I would do commercials for that much. I don't care who I'm selling out to.
Well, anyway,
you sell out.
Shut the fuck up, Winkleman. The point I was trying to make about 45 minutes ago is that in that video. Where he said, you're the homos. That was pretty much the tipping point. Because had Chris handled that the correct way, the trolls would have...
Handling things the correct
way. But, like, had he had the foresight to handle it correctly, the trolls would have left him alone after, like, a couple of months.
Yeah, but he still would have fucked up his life, man.
But no, he fucked up and called them.
No, he would have fucked up his life. It just would not have been as public.
True.
That's the thing, is just that's the ongoing debate, is like, would Chris, you know, be is Chris getting better? Well, no, he would have been just as fucked up.
A lot.
But
hi. How you doing? I'm Chris Chan. You're the homos.
Harry Carey?
Yeah. How you doing?
Hello. Holy cow.
I'm Chris Chan. You're the homos. I hear you're homosexuals. You pick up young men in your car.
Okay.
Well, that
there's
was...
There's a line here, and I don't know where it was.
I think
we have a line.
Get in the fucking room, Winkleman. Jesus Christ. How long are you going to stall?
I am. What did you didn't?
There's the line. There's the line right there.
Oh, is H G?
Don't say it out loud, you fucking idiot.
It's U 4-7.
Winkleman, have you been pre-gaming again?
Yes, of course I have been.
God damn it.
You sick monkey ass.
You sick little monkey.
It's called Trivia Murder Party, for fuck's sake.
It's called you fucking wacky ass.
What's the website?
It's jackbox.tv. That's where you go to do the stupid shit. No, that's actually CultureShockTV.tk. That's where you go to do the stupid shit.
Wait, CultureShock? What's that?
I don't know.
I don't know what that is.
A bunch of morons do.
Where's the people that said they were going to be here, like Billy and Jace and Rick? And this Michael St. Pierre guy that said he was coming? Where are these fucking people at that said they were going to show up?
Because you said show start, like... starts at, like, 10, so they're gonna probably get here for 10.
I'm calling that stupid ass Bill Cosby.
Yeah, I'm calling you.
What a fuck are you?
I didn't know that. Freeman or anything. I mean, come on.
I mean, now that you know who Mike is, the other Mike is the boar guy who was in last week.
Oh, he's boar or whatever. That's cool.
It was,
gee, Adam. Winkman, are you cum yarper?
No.
No, you clearly are, though.
No.
No, you no, but I mean, you clearly are. Not only are you cum yarper, but you're pink as well. It's like it's so perfect.
I love how I mean, anime one and I've got tentacles.
I didn't get a choice of my color, but
no, you didn't.
I think it's
nobody
I think
does.
It's appropriate.
It's actually it's actually randomized every time. Like I'm not always even I'm not always gray.
When so I
you're not always a literal sack.
Yeah, I'm not always a literal sack of shit. Dane's like an angry fucking moblin or some shit. Adam's a fucking undead Patrick, and then Michelle's a squid.
Are we
still live on the...
yeah, we are live.
Bill said he'll be here in about 10-15 minutes.
Okay.
So the poor person who I was actually talking to on Facebook beforehand, I was on a Facebook video chat beforehand, and I'm like, oh shit, Dane, so I'm like...
I hear something really adorable.
It's my anus.
Is it totes adorbs or is it just adorable?
It's totes McGoats.
Totes Mc... What? Are we back in the 80s?
Damn.
No, we're back in 2014, apparently.
Totes Mc...
Oh, crap. The worst year of my life.
Get ready to have painters in your bedroom for a year.
That was 2015, Mike. That painter's thing was last year.
No, that's why I know. I said get ready for that.
Yeah, get ready for
it
some
more. It hasn't happened
more.
Yet. Get ready for more of that.
Get ready for some more, bitch.
Get ready for some more prison bitches.
Yo, bitch.
What? What? What about more prison bitches?
Adam has them. Benarchik, I mean.
Get ready for some more reason.
I was going to say, his whole country is filled with prison bitches.
This is true, but there's no reason for you to point it out. Just because Australia started as a penal colony does not mean it's okay to point it out.
You mean just because Australia has continued as a penal colony?
You're a penal colony.
I am.
The emphasis on the penal part. Adam cum yarper Winkleman.
Yes. Adam cum yarper Winkleman. I did a search for Flossman on Google. Dane, where do you think I rated on it?
I think you rated an F. Forget about it.
Place-wise.
Anything F plus. To... S no, double God. Plus.
I was asking Dane, not you, prison bitch.
He's not the prison bitch, though. He has the prison bitches.
Sorry, prison bastard.
That doesn't even make any sense.
I literally said my answer like 6 times.
Adam,
no one's listening to me.
Adam, if you are killing the meme, congrats, but I don't know what's you doing.
I don't know what's you doing.
That's a pickles.
I don't know what you're doing. But that was more of a scottish.
What the fuck kind of accent was that?
I don't know what you're doing.
I don't know what you're doing. Ugh.
Adam,
laddie,
that
is not... totally wrong part of the world, laddie.
He's channeling, fucking Metalocalypse. Shut up, Pickles. You are the stupid.
Shut up, Pickles. You're the stupid.
You're the stupid.
Oh,
You're so stupid.
You're so stupid.
Just because you're so stupid. You think this song is all about you.
That's not how it goes.
No.
I don't care.
That would totally... That would totally rename the song if it was You're So Stupid.
Yeah.
I just googled my handle and I'm the entire first page.
Okay, anyway, to answer the question that Winkleman was asked me about 7 years ago. I would say you were around 7 or 8.
I am the third. Ooh. Actually, and it's my Kiwi Farms.
Oh, poor Lord.
That's the saddest thing. But when I used to actually have
Layla,
I had for about 5 years.
I guarantee
Flossmat.org as my.
I guarantee that if you searched your actual name, Adam Winkleman, you'd probably be half the first page because it'd all be just this stuff.
Yeah.
I swear to God, true story. About a year ago,
I'm fucking in Memphis. Fucking with my cum out on the floor.
No.
What? Wow.
I come yabba, no. Put your katana down.
Welcome to fucking musical theater with Adam Flossman Winkleman Cum Yarper.
No.
Don't make me wait much, Foss.
No. Adam's a promising young singer. I wish he promised to stop singing.
No!
Yes. No. We should. Shut up, Dane.
We should shut up, Dane.
Last year.
Hi, 24 Grit, whomever you may be. I don't know, but.
The last year, I actually was Google searching different members of the mental cast in our associates.
Were you?
And I did a Google image search of Mike Riley. First picture.
Was a penis?
No. First picture was a fat, smiling black man. And I was just like, Michael?
If there's one thing about me that is abundantly clear is that I'm black.
Yeah. That's me. Welcome to the Metalcast, sucker.
Welcome to the Metalcast, fool!
Oh, hell yeah, welcome to the Metalcast, motherfucker.
Metalcast in Harlem,
welcome
bitch.
The Montelcast.
The Montelcast.
The Montelcast.
This pronounce it properly, y'all.
No. I'm here with Kanisha, Leticia, Phonisha, and Boney.
And that's just Chelsea.
Mike, I don't hate to tell you this, but it's the Montel cast.
Okay.
From now on.
I mean, that's what I figured, but by the way, is everybody who's on the call? Yeah, everybody who's on the call is in the room, so I'll just unhide the code because we're going to start in about 5 minutes anyway. Hey, Rizmix and 24 Grit. I don't know who 24 Grit is. I know who Rizmix is. If I could say his name correctly, it'd be great. But
what happened to the other 23 Grits?
I don't know.
Cato.
They were in Alice's Grits that she told you to kiss. Kiss my Grits.
You kiss my Grits.
Kiss my Grits, rub my feet.
No,
fuck my
hell
butt.
Yeah, Kiss my grits. This is what
kiss
saying.
My grits and suck my. Never mind.
Suck
my tits.
What?
Something about tits. I don't know.
Heard me.
Kiss
my grits and suck my tits.
Yeah, something like that.
Well, Dane always talks about tits, but
it's true.
Yes, that's true. Yeah, because you know, there's nobody else on this call that talks endlessly about boobs.
Or as I overheard in a club one night, I'm gonna suck your tits like chocolate chips.
Excuse me?
Actually, no. Let me back up. It was
I don't believe you. No, shut up. That's exactly what happened.
By the way,
I don't care what you
say. Is 24 Grit somebody that we know? Is that Jace?
Hello. Jace?
Because the host name is Massachusetts, so I'm thinking it's either Jace or somebody Michelle knows.
I was going to say, I asked if it was my friend who I linked to this, and they're like, no, I'm folding laundry. I haven't joined the chat room. I'm like, all right.
No problem. Bye.
You're a jerk, but okay.
So anyway, I was at a club a few years ago. And
a few years ago.
This one guy was trying
when
to
you
date.
When you were still young enough to go to clubs.
Yeah. So this one guy, I swear to you, said to a girl who he was dancing with, "I'm going to suck your nips like chocolate chips."
That's weird.
I don't eat. No. No.
Is not that, hey, look, works. when I worked as a KJ in Texas. KJ.
What the fuck is a KJ?
Karaoke jockey. When I worked I was a karaoke host. When I worked as a KJ, that's what they call it, was a KJ. When I worked as one in Texas, I saw...
No one ever called...
No, that is what... For whom I was employed, that's what they were called.
They just said that to make you feel better.
No. I know it's a karaoke host. It's a PR job. But still, that's not even here or there. Look, the fact of the matter is I saw a lot of weird shit go down when I was hosting karaoke. I have seen at least 20 to 25 pairs of tits. I've had a woman sing on stage while lifting her shirt up.
Okay, I'm glad you said 25 pairs.
Yeah, pairs of tits. Because there's a 25 tits. One woman just had one boob.
I love me some.
I love my uniboob, lady.
Listen, I love me a woman with a vasectomy.
If everybody could just hush up for a second, I actually had the actual audio from the first night where Mike was a KJ.
A VJ. I worked for MTV for a brief period in the 80s.
This was the first guy that ever came.
VJ?
Listen.
Hello. I love you, bitch.
I'm here.
I ain't gonna never stop loving you, bitch. I love you, bitch.
No.
Yeah. I once had an admittedly drunk woman not only lift her shirt up, but then grab my hands and place them on her breasts. And then she proceeded to grab my junk. This woman was married, by the way.
Oh dear!
I'm just like, you're drunk and you're married, and I'm not so sure this is a good idea.
I'm glad that one of the first things you did was look at her left hand, Mike.
Hey, wait,
look at that.
What are you fucking talking about,
Mike? Yes. Tommy Harper on.
What's that, Bill?
Tommy Harper on today.
Yes, yeah. Tommy Harper is on. I showed him the picture. I showed him a still frame from that from last night.
Tom Harper is
the room Tom code. Billy, the room code is HU. It's huge if you're dyslexic, just like me.
Oh, whoa! I got yelled at by Sam.
I've unveiled the code on the stream now, though, so it's okay now. But
you've unveiled.
It was hidden at the time you tried to say it.
I just realized something.
What'd you realize?
That this we're all perverts.
Yes. Well, that's one thing.
This call's gonna be a cluster.
Eh. It'll be fine. I'm gonna be doing most of the talking because you guys gotta hear the questions and shit, and see what mini games are gonna be playing. So,
Mike, I'm gonna be doing most of the talking.
No, you're not. I will mute your ass. If I have to, I will mute you. I will mute you so everybody else can hear what's going on.
He has the power.
I do have the power to do that. So you will learn your place, cum yarper.
Again, you don't know. I bet Mike doesn't have.
What do I not have, Michelle?
I bet Mike doesn't have the cojones to mute cum yarper.
Yarper.
Yeah, yarper.
There, just did it.
Yeah. Let's see how long it takes for him to notice.
Carl yarpers.
How would you know if he notices or not? He's muted.
Yeah, but he could type into the chat.
There we go. I unmuted him. I noticed. He was muted, not deafened, so he could still hear us.
Yeah, I can.
Oh, it's 10:00. Look at that. Let's do this. Hello, everybody. Okay. Welcome to MVGDead's last night of MVGDead before we go back to being MVGLive next week. And we're playing more Trivia Murder Party. And tonight, from right to left, in the green is 24 Grit, in the yellow is Michelle, and the red and the orange is Adam. Gray is me, pink is Adam Flossman, red is Dane, and that blue one over there is Billy.
Hi.
Billy. Why do I hear crying Australian infants?
Construction.
I live in Australia.
That's the only way Australian infants know how to communicate.
Everybody's in. Let's hit it.
So you mean to tell me that infants are doing construction outside your door?
Yep.
That's how it goes.
That's child labor laws are really not as strict. Not as strict. Starring Mental Mike as Gray Sack. Murder Chan as Squid, Dane as Angry Minion, Cum Yarper as Voodoo Doll, and introducing Hump Asuka as a shark.
Thank God I don't want to have children, otherwise Voodoo Doll or Cum Yarper
will be their name.
Picks. Yeah. Probably Cum
Yarper. Alright guys, here we go. Question one, 7 of us on the call. You gotta answer questions. If you answer wrong, you have to play minigame for your life. What year does Marty McFly travel back to in Back to the Future? That's an easy one. Is it 1955, 1956, 1957, 1958? It's really easy if you think about it. If you think about it hard enough. Think about all the other years he's traveled to in the series.
Think about it. Oh my god. Does it end in a 5?
Probably. It was year 1962.
1962?
I actually don't know the answer.
It's 1955.
Is the answer. Someone kind of gave it away because they asked if it ends in a 5.
Yeah, 24 Grit. Guys, come on. 24 Grit got it wrong, so he's going to the Killing Room. Killing Floor, I should say. Killing Room is a different game. Killing Room is a game, actually, but it's not this game. 24 Grit, you're playing Loser Wheel, which means you're probably screwed. All you gotta do is spin the wheel and hope to God it lands on life. Go for it, 24-pack, 24-grit, 24-pack, whatever.
24-pack.
Spin the wheel.
Life, death.
Alright, 24-grit has spun.
I just love it when she spins.
Lands on death, sorry. 24-grit, you are dead.
No one has spun life.
Well, I mean, they're very tiny slivers. It would be very hard to do that. So the first one dead is 24 Grit. Don't worry, death is not the end. You can still keep playing, and hopefully maybe you could win, even as a ghost. Doesn't matter. All right.
Zombie. Werewolf.
Next question. Question 2. Let's do this. Question 2 is, what is Dumbledore's first name? Is it?
Which one?
Albin, Albus, Alvis, or Alvin? The Dumbledore that falls into this category, apparently.
Because
he
fell in
two. Everybody's in. The correct answer is Albus, of course. Albus is the answer. Everybody got it right.
God, I got it right, and I feel so bad about myself because I've never read Harry Potter.
Me neither. Question 3. Here we go. How often does Mars go into retrograde? Is it every year, every 2 years, every 4 years, or every 8 years? I don't know this one either. Yeah, don't feel bad, Michelle. I don't know this one either.
No, I'm trying to use word clues of retro and grade and try to guess it.
I don't know if there's anything in there that would tell you that explicitly. Every 2 years is the answer. I guessed it right. Holy shit. Only me and Dane got it right. So, Michelle, Adam, and Billy go to the Killing Floor. I guessed, too, so I kind of feel bad about that. I should be on the Killing Floor, too.
Wouldn't be the first time I've been on the Killing Floor.
All right, you four.
I hope it doesn't give us the finger one.
No, you guys are playing chalices. Me and Dane and 24 Grit have poison pellets. We're going to pick a chalice to put the poison in.
Ooh, I like poison.
So, me, Dane, and 24 Grit are choosing a chalice for poison. Our poison.
Poison's the worst thing.
Does it smell like almonds?
At least one of you, unless y'all pick the same chalice, at least one of you should live. Alright.
Is that genuine screaming?
Michelle, Adam, and Billy, pick a chalice to drink from. And Billy's in. All right, let's do this.
Mike, is that screaming genuinely coming from your side, or is someone torturing
you? If you picked 1, 6, and 7, 1, 6, or 7, you're dead. Michelle and Ozzy Adam are dead.
I hear screaming.
That's machine.
Yeah, it's Adam in the background. Yeah, a saw blade is screaming bloody murder somewhere.
Yeah, because the garden.
I want to run through your wicked garden. Question 4. Guys.
Probably not a real music
fan. No.
Question 4. What monster does not get mentioned in the Monster Mash? Is it Frankenstein, Wolfman, Dracula, or Dracula's son? I didn't know Dracula's son was a monster.
Well, I mean, in the song. Well, I mean, not to give
it. So don't pick 4, whatever you do. It's Frankenstein.
Yeah, no, Dane. Why did you say that 2 seconds earlier?
Only Dane and Billy got it right.
How did Dracula have a son?
Well, me and Flossie are going to the killing floor.
Murder.
You got it right, Michelle, so shut your mouth.
No, she didn't get it right. She's dead. Yeah, it doesn't matter if she gets it wrong, because she's already dead. Billy, choose whether we should roll higher or lower than 8. Because me and Flossie are playing dice. He has chosen for us to roll higher than 8 to live. Alright. Flossie, you and I get to roll now.
Oh, God. Is this a D20?
Lucky you, we both live. Congratulations.
Yay!
I rolled a 16, he rolled a 13. Congratulations.
So this is a D20. Nice.
Well, it was 3D6s, so D18, I guess?
So much fun right now.
No, just be 3D6s in terms of...
Yeah, that's not how it works.
I don't give a shit. I don't play D&D. Question 5.
Yo, well, you should.
I probably won't.
It's fun.
I'm too fat. Question 5.
Memories of public school.
Which character from the Hunger Games died first? Is it Thresh, Clove, Rue, or Kato? No fucking clue. I saw the movie and I don't even know.
I seen a movie, now I know.
I'm assuming that the movie and the book are basically the same in that regard. Like, they wouldn't change a major plot point unless they're total assholes.
They can't. It wouldn't
this
make any sense.
No. I don't know this.
Yeah, I don't either. The correct answer is Rue. I guessed it right. I don't believe it. Me and Billy got it right. So, Dane and Flossie get to go to the killing floor.
Murder!
Dane and Flossie! Dane and Flossie, you get to play memory. So, be looking at the stream. Look at this. This blood spattered pattern on this thing. Memorize it. You got about 5-10 seconds.
Yeah, and the stream catches up.
Yeah, no, the stream's lagging way behind.
Yeah, that actually should help you more than hurt you, because then you get to enter it while you're looking at it for a second.
Can I take a screenshot?
No, that would be outright cheating.
I'll give you the two or three seconds
that you're seeing it while you're entering it, because there's nothing that can be done about that, but don't take a screenshot.
I think Kamyapa's cheating.
No, Kamyarper would not treat.
Alright.
Well,
Dane and Flossie reproduce the pattern.
I never got the pattern. I'm not fucking kidding.
Well, person who does the worst dies, so you're just gonna have to bite the rock, I guess.
There's a Tetris piece, and then there's a Tetris piece, and then there's another,
and there's another
piece,
Tetris piece, and there's another Tetris piece, and there's a Tetris piece from like
the
N64 version. And then there's a Tetris piece from that fucking N64 version that nobody played.
You mean Tetris Speeder?
And then there's Tetris one. And then there's the Tetris one that you end up like going to different worlds and it's really actually a lot of fun. It's actually got a story.
Hey, Michelle.
Dane got 72% of the thing. Adam actually got 64%, so you did good considering, but you still die though, Flossie.
Fuck.
But not by much, so take pride in that.
Michelle,
I think you've been playing Tetris on LSD. Hate to tell you.
Next question. Question 6 is as follows. What's the head on a ship? Is it the toilet, the bedroom, the closet, the kitchen? I actually know this.
Everyone should know this.
I mean, it should be, like, because, like, that's parlance, regular parlance for most people. Hitting the head, you go to the toilet.
I'm going to say one thing.
Michelle missed it, but she's already a ghost, so it doesn't matter. So everybody else got it, we move on.
Michelle's being quite nasty today.
Question 7.
I'm looking for a new pet, but I want something with a scary name. This labradoodle just isn't good for me.
What type of animal is a hellbender? Is it a spider, a salamander, a snake, or a turtle? I have no idea.
It really doesn't matter what I pick.
I mean, you don't get any extra score for guessing wrong, but... It's salamander. Salamander is the answer.
Yes!
I missed it. I'm the only one that missed it. Well, Michelle missed it too, but she's a ghost.
I picked turtle.
We're playing math, and is this everybody's playing? Answer as many math questions as you can before time runs out. If anybody does better than me, I die.
Dude,
Mike,
I'm
murdering you so hard.
Ready, set, go. Math.
I'm frozen.
What? Ah, shit!
From a textbook that I found in a backpack, that I found in a body, that I found in an alley.
Fuck me. Ah, shit, Dick! Ah, fuck me! In the ass! Oh, fuck! Oh, I made 17, 24 grit made 18. I got beat by one. One math problem killed me. If I fucking hadn't have fucked up on those two. Son of a dick.
I got a question that said 3 equals 1.
Three
it's
minus.
Supposed to be a minus sign.
It should be minus, I think. Dane and Billy are still alive, by the way, so we keep moving on. Question 8.
I'm gonna beat you, Carter.
Which of the following cookies is produced by Nabisco? I think he's got you on this, Dane. Sandy's, Lorna Doone, Dunkaroos, or Star Crunch? I think I know this.
I'm a cookie junkie myself.
I think
I know
this.
Sandy's.
Oh, this.
The correct answer is Lorna Doone. I was right. Yeah, me and 24. So, Dane and Billy go to the killing floor.
Oh, that was a swerve. I thought it was Sandy's.
No, Lorna Doone.
You pick Sandy's too, so did I.
All right, Dane and Billy, you get to play Arena. You get to choose whether... You have to choose whether to attack, defend yourself, or grab the money. Do so now.
The Donald Trump way.
Attack, defend, or grab the money.
Do it the Trump way.
I kind of feel like I know Billy's strategy, so I'm going to go with this.
The anti-Trump way?
Hurry, Dane.
Oops.
All right, Billy grabbed the money. Dane attacked.
Hurt each other.
So then, what does that mean?
Billy dies. You attacked, he grabbed the money, he didn't defend himself, so you killed him.
No hard feelings.
That's fine.
That means Dane is the last one left alive, so it's time for Dane to run for his life.
Oh boy.
So
I think Bill's kind of pissed off.
Dane's got a... We're gonna get shown a category and a bunch of possible choices. We pick all the choices that fit in that category. We move one space ahead for everyone we get right. Dane gets a head start category, though, that only he gets to get. Dane, your category for your head start question is... The Daily Show alumni. Wyatt Cenac. We're just all playing. Okay, never mind. Daily Show alumni. Wyatt Cenac, Joss Gad, Rob Riggle. Oh, fuck! I just realized I made an error.
An error.
By the way, all of them or none of them could be the correct answer.
This is true. All or none could be, but they're all the correct answers. So that's, I made an error. I forgot Josh Gad was on the Daily Show.
I knew
yep. he was.
The ghosts, by the way, get a third option that the alive person cannot see. Babysitter's Club novels. Stacy Races the Dead, Dawn and the Surfer Ghost, Christy and the Cat Burglar.
Stacy Races the Dead.
Hey, you don't know. You don't know. There could be some occult shit going on here.
I don't know.
Dawn and the Surfer Ghost and Christy and the Cat Burglar are the answers.
You don't know, man. You were there.
Cartoon characters with mustaches. Bob Belcher, Luigi, Lorax.
Well, see, we're gonna be splitting hairs because
I think you'll find that they are all the correct answer. Yeah, Bob Belcher has a mustache too, Adam.
Hey, Linda. Shadows.
Mountain Dew flavors. Bladterific, Sugar Buzz, Throwback.
I want to
drink Mountain Dew Bladterific.
It's like poo.
Excuse me, it's Diet Double Dew. It's got half the
Dew.
Double Dew.
Only Throwback was the correct answer there, so yeah.
Nuka-Cola Quantum.
Me and Billy are catching up to Dane.
Twice the calories, twice the caffeine.
Games that require dice. Clue, Cranium, The Settlers of Catan.
Catan is awesome.
It's a pretty fun game. I've seen it.
I've played Settlers of Catan. It's a big game.
I've never played it.
You should. It's fun.
Cluedo
in European market,
to
yes.
To us,
probably. So it was Coup. Coup is
all
awesome.
Three are right. I'm an idiot. Dane's about to get out of here unscathed, guys. I
believe in you. Okay, we need to kill his ass.
Salads that contain hard-boiled eggs. Waldorf salad, Greek salad, Caprese salad.
That one.
None of those are correct, by the way. None of them were.
I said none of them.
Yeah.
Ideally, they would all...
European capitals, Stockholm, Bern, Frankfurt.
Oh man, Mike and Bill are breathing down.
Yeah, Mike and me and Billy are right behind. Stockholm and Bern are correct. Oh, Dane's almost out the door. I took over Dane. I'm in the lead. I took his body. Next category.
Why would you
German,
want to
German
body?
German car manufacturers: Rolls-Royce, Jeep, Audi.
Wait, what?
German car manufacturers: Rolls-Royce, Jeep, or Audi.
Oh, it's not Jeep.
I mean...
That's right here in my town.
Dur. Only Audi is the correct answer. I have bad news for you guys. I just got out the door. I win.
You're a whore.
Sweet, guys. I just got an Audi. He just got it.
I've got an Annie.
Audi. Okay.
I won by the skin of my teeth. It was the Waldorf it was the salad answer that really got me.
The salad screwed me.
Is everybody playing again? Are we all just going to play again? Should I just hit reboot franchise or play a sequel? Yes. Yeah, let's do this. I'm gonna cut segment here real quick. Let's do this again. Play a sequel. By the way, everybody who died in the last game will now be their name, but Junior.
Junior.
No, Trivia Murder Boston. Party 2, the sequel. Let's do this.
Become your Junior?
So yeah, anybody who died in the last game is now yourself but Junior. Question
come
1.
Junior.
Yes. First question. Let's go, guys. Here we go. The second largest consumer of Guinness beer after the United Kingdom is what country? This seems like it's up Adam's Flossman's alley. Ireland, China, the U.S., or Nigeria? I feel like it's that. Because they drink... I've seen a lot of Guinness drank in this part of the world.
Drank.
I just said them all because I know one of them is right. And the correct answer is... it's Nigeria. Damn. Wow, I never would have guessed that. Only Dane got it right. Wow. Six people are going to the killing floor.
I figured it was the U.S. because I
said
that
too. I thought that was right. I see a lot of people drink Guinness here.
Everyone's gonna die questions.
Yeah.
Alright. We're playing fingers.
Just
choose one of your fingers to cut off. Choose a finger to cut off. No, you have to cut off one of your fingers. Yeah, if you don't cut one off, you die.
Oh, that's just what happens if you cut
one off. That is what happens. We've seen that happen.
Okay.
Whatever finger you cut off, that answer is no longer selectable to you for the rest of the game until you die. So even if it's the right answer, it'll still show up as a finger. So sorry about your luck.
Oh, well.
Sorry about your damn.
So you better hope whatever you picked isn't the answer for the most of the questions.
Sorry for your loss.
Dane NYCFC Jr. is in the lead. Question two.
Here we go. Kill their babbies.
Make us better.
Except me. I'm comfortable with my current evil output. Alright, here's the question. Antonio Salieri was the rival of which classical composer? Is the answer Mozart, Beethoven, Bach, or Schubert? Fuck me, I hope it's not that one.
I know what it was. I think.
I hope.
Since I've seen Amadeus.
You fucking nerd.
You stupid bastard.
It's like, have that movie. I should watch it.
I hope it's not the third answer. I hope it's not Bob. It's Mozart. Okay, I missed it anyway. It's okay. So, me, Michelle, and 24 Creator going to the killing room.
The killing
room. Yeah, no, I couldn't
killing
pick
floor,
the answer.
God damn it. Killing room, killing floor, whatever. Oh, there's a pile of cash. This isn't good.
This is the who's going to be addicted.
Me, Michelle, and 24 Creator playing Greed.
That's weird.
Not the show hosted by Chuck Woolery.
Okay. So, we need to just figure out something.
Take the most or the least money, and you will be punished.
Oh!
So write a number, pick a number between 1 and 1,000.
This is different.
Take the most and the least, and you'll be punished.
Take the most or the least, and you will be punished.
40 billion.
So whoever does not take the most or the least will not be killed.
A billion spillion.
Alright. I took 500. Michelle took 500. And 24 Grit took 666. We all die! Thanks. Michelle and I, you and I both took the least amount, so we all die.
Thanks. You put 502?
Yes, I did. So, thanks to that, all three of us are dead.
Killed, jerk.
24-3 is a...
Hey, I entered my answer first, so you killed me. Which is what you wanted.
Okay, well,
question three. Next question is...
See, at least we got the money we stole.
True. What planet is nearest in size to Earth? Is it Mars, Venus, Jupiter, Saturn? I think I actually do believe I know the answer to this. If my science classes in school have taught me anything.
Fucking A. Why must I have?
I've never heard. I've never heard of a planet called Fucking A.
I have.
It's right next to Fucking B.
It's in the Dagobah system.
You gotta pick something, Adam.
I do. Oh well.
Yeah. The correct answer is Venus. I think that's that's the finger answer from Adam.
Yep.
He couldn't select it. Adam and Billy, Flossman and Billy, get to go to the killing floor.
I'm sad that I died because
the pile of cash is back. You're playing decisions, or the who's going to be a dick game. If you take the money, he will kill everyone who didn't. But if you all take the money, you all die. Feel free to shout to Mandy. It's the prisoner's dilemma.
They were
really quick in on the draw with that. Nobody took the money.
Ooh.
Nobody took the money, so Adam and Billy are not dicks to each other. They get to live.
No,
I've always said that Bill and Plausible.
You've never said that in your life.
Question four.
2014 was a magical year.
2014 was not a magical year. Fuck you. Murderer.
There was that,
He
doesn't remember crap about 2014. Where were the 2014 Winter Olympics held? Was it Salzburg, Salt Lake City, Sochi, or Beijing?
Shit. Okay, Mario and Sonic games. Mario and Sonic games.
That'll help, actually. No, I mean, if she's trying to remember the Mario and Sonic game titles, I mean, that would help tremendously.
I said peepees. That's a...
No peepees?
No peepees. No peepees.
Peepees is not
It's Sochi, by the way. Sochi is the correct answer. Billy missed it. He's going to the killing floor.
I didn't have it.
It doesn't matter. I mean, it was 2 years ago. How do you forget that?
I didn't even watch it.
Billy's gonna play words. Actually, we're all gonna play words. Billy, you're gonna use the letters in front of you that you're gonna have on the grid to spell out the longest word you can. The letters don't have to be connected on the grid. Just spell the longest word you can. It has to be a word, though. If anybody spells a longer word than you, you die.
Start poking those letters with your fingers. You're almost out of time.
Fuck, I don't... Whatever.
I can't spell anything.
It's very hard. Time's up. What you
came up with. Damn it.
Billy spelled pleading, which is 18. That may actually be a word. I think it is.
Pleading.
Nobody else was able to spell a word, so Billy wins. Billy gets to live.
I couldn't.
I was looking at that grid going like, what the fuck am I supposed to spell with this?
I'm like, I'm
sure there's a word there, but I don't have a big enough vocabulary to think of it.
I was trying to spell pelican, and I had one letter missing.
What type of animal is an ibex? Is it a giant cat, a wild goose, a giant snake, or a wild goat?
Well, that's easy.
The more you know.
I don't like this game.
I turned down my nose.
Why can't you pick, Adam?
Not know this.
Full finger. That's why.
You have to pick something.
I'll pick one gangster. I'm losing anyway.
It's a wild goat. Yeah. Me and I missed it too, but Adam is the only alive person that missed it, so he's going to the killing floor. I mean, if you're going to miss it anyway, you might as well pick instead of wasting a bunch of time. Adam's picking actually, everybody's playing patterns. Memorize the pattern on the stream in front of you there when it comes up.
Yeah, it'll pop up.
Here, I'll read it off. It's blue gun, blue grenade, blue gun, yellow gun, yellow sword. That's all you get. I'm not going to repeat it. Speaking of memories, I can never remember. I hope you remembered what I just said. Llamas are smaller and have shorter ears. Do, he's talking about llamas trying to throw us off. Backwards. Or did I? I honestly
don't know. See what I mean? Okay. Let's see how you'll do. Alright,
what was the order of colors? Order of colors from left to right. Go. And all you have to do is simply make sure not a single person does. Yellow might have been orange, by the way.
That's what I
mean, if you're paying enough attention to what I said, this should be easy.
I got distracted. So I lost. I'm dead.
It depends if anybody did better than you. That's what it's based on. Everybody's in. It's the colors were blue, 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 orange, orange. There were no greens whatsoever. Adam got one right out of five. Would anyone do better than you? Everybody else got 5 out of 5. Adam's dead. That's what I'm talking
about. Told ya.
I love you.
You also said yellow.
Yeah, I may have meant orange. It looked yellow to me.
Be fair, it looked yellow.
Yeah. I'm sure you could have figured it out once I said a color that didn't show up as a choice, you could figure out what I meant.
Okay, Adam Sandler.
I'm going to poop on your butt.
I don't know what that means. Question 6. Question 6 is... Who is the funny named narrator of the Dr. Seuss book, If I Ran the Circus? Is it Morris McGurk, Dirk McShirk, Larry McBurk, or Jay McJerk?
Jerk-a-ma-jerk.
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 Oh, it's this one.
There are certain lines even Dr. Seuss would never...
It was Morris McGurk.
Oh, hell yeah!
Billy's the only living person that missed that, so he goes to the killing floor.
Again.
Billy, you're gonna play the loser's wheel. Enjoy. Spin it for your life.
Nice knowing you, Bill.
Yep.
This never works out in anybody's favor.
Now watch he gets the life
bar. Is that the best wheel?
Nope. Landed on death. Billy loses.
I hate you all.
Billy is dead.
Oh my God.
The only two left alive at this point are Dane and Flossie.
Get you, Flossie.
Cum Yarper.
Yeah, Cum Yarper Jr.
I was about to say, I'm Cum Yarper, thank you.
Cum Yarper Jr. Question 7.
Cum Yarper Jr.
Cum Yarper Whopper Jr.
Alright.
Jane and I. You know what? You're Jane for the remainder of the night.
Alright.
Jane for Jane and Cum Yarper Jr.
Where does quinoa come from? Is it Africa, South America, Europe, or Asia?
What? Oh, God, I did this at college.
What?
I did this at college, I said.
Is this a drug? Is it a drug?
I don't know.
What?
That's part of the essay.
Sure.
You call it. Essay, want to do some quinoa?
You took it up the ass, eh?
Is there a paper, please?
South America is the correct answer.
I think. Yeah.
Flossie missed it. He's the only one. He goes to killing floor. This could be the end of the one. It's not a drug, by the way. Somebody in the person in the, or the lovely person in the chat points out.
I believe it's a food.
We're playing chalices.
Yes.
All right. Everybody who is not Flossman, put a chalice to poison. Put your poison in a chalice.
Put the chalice to poison.
That means there's only going to be, well, depending on who put what where. I mean, there's a possibility that there may only be one safe chalice.
Throw massive.
It's a grain. Thank you. That's what I thought.
Just throw massive amounts of opium everywhere and hemlock.
All right, everybody's put their poison in a chalice, so Flossman, pick a chalice to drink from. May you choose wisely.
I realize something.
May the odds be ever in your favor.
Adam has picked the sixth chalice. He's safe.
That's why I prefer
the loser wheel. Ooh. Everybody put... Only two of the chalices were poisoned. Like, everybody just put their poison in the same two chalices.
The odds are ever in my favor.
You chose wisely.
We are so dumb.
Dane and Flossie are still alive. We keep going. Question 8. Here we go.
Just so you know, this question isn't
Jane
and Flossie.
Jane. How many quarts are in a gallon? Is it 2, 4, 6, or 8?
Who do we appreciate?
By the way, I didn't know that Dane was a song by Starship.
Oh,
Jane, I'm counting on you.
Oh my goodness, I think this might be a sign in Australia. Halloween safety tips.
4 is the correct answer. 4 quarts to a gallon, you drunk bastard. Flossin's going to the killing floor.
I couldn't choose 4.
Oh, that's right. You had a finger.
Yeah.
All right, we're playing dice. The murderer rolled 12.
Should they roll higher?
I don't recognize who that is. It's pick. Oh, it's Adam. Adam, pick whether he should roll higher or lower than 12. Adam Bednarczyk.
I got it.
All right. So you have to roll higher than 12, Flossman. Do it.
Easy.
You can do it.
You've rolled an 8. You're dead.
Fuck.
So easy.
I appreciate it.
So once again, Dane is the last one alive. It's time for Dane to run for his life.
Oh God, I hear the spirits behind me.
Hey, Dane!
Something Dane hears every day.
What, Michelle?
All right, everybody, get ready. Here we go, let's do it.
Run.
First category. Everybody's playing. Instructions in the cha-cha slide. Cha-cha real smooth. Slide to the left. Crisscross.
Bum, bum.
Chum, chum.
Slide. I hate that song.
I like that song.
Charlie Brown.
All of them. They're all correct. I was doing the clap, like in the cha-cha slide. All three are right, by the way. Left-handed NBA players. David Robinson, Manu Ginobili, Michael Jordan.
Jeez.
I don't know any of...
I don't either. I don't watch basketball. I'm in the same boat you are, Michelle.
I only watch Space Jam.
Michael Jordan was in that.
It's a Space Jam.
Here's your chance.
I think David Robinson might have been in it too. David Robinson and Manu are the two answers there. Michael Jordan's right-handed.
Manu Ginobili.
I managed to pick the one that was right-handed.
Voiced by Frank Oz, the voice of Yoda. Ernie, Rizzo the Rat, Sam the Eagle.
Ooh.
From the director of Bowfinger.
From the director of Buttfinger. Ooh.
No, I'm gonna guess. I'm not gonna win this.
Only
so
Sam.
Guess.
Only
I'm
Sam the Eagle. Sam the Eagle is the correct answer. The only one. You are all weirdos.
The opposite.
You're all weirdos.
Yep. Seven Wonders of the Ancient World, ESPN Sports Center, Pyramids of Giza, or the Hanging Gardens of Babylon. Like, one of those is very obviously not the right answer.
Obviously,
you mean the Hanging Gardens.
Yes, exactly. But just fucking me with this. The Pyramids and the Hanging Gardens are correct, obviously. He's gonna fucking run away with this one again.
Hanging Pyramids.
Sports Center was not.
Hold on. Game. Trivial Pursuit Genius Edition categories: Lives and Times, Entertainment, Potpourri. I used to play a shit ton of Trivial Pursuit, so I should know this.
I was
Me
raised
too.
On Trivial
I
Pursuit.
I love Trivial Pursuit. I watched the TV show with Wink Martindale. I watched the TV show in the 90s with Wink Martindale.
I had a terrible childhood.
Me too. We all did.
PS2 video game, and it was voiced by like the guy who voiced the gorilla in Tarzan, Bill Nye, Whoopi Goldberg's in it.
What?
Such an eclectic group of voice actors. Who has not answered yet? Get your answers in quick. Running out of time.
Distracted by the sultry sounds.
Only entertainment is correct. Next.
If anyone picked Potpourri, I'm gonna kick their ass.
Rodents, squirrel, chinchilla, vampire bat.
A chinchilla.
Chinchilla.
You know what a chinchilla is? I've seen one before. They're really soft and furry.
Just think chinchilla.
The squirrel and the chinchilla are rodents, yes.
Oh, fuck.
Next. Yeah, Tank keeps missing him. 24 Grit Jr. might catch up. Subatomic particles, megaton, amino, Paxton.
Bill Paxton?
Bill Paxton.
There was another Bill. Yeah. There was another Bill, an evil Bill, and I killed him.
Yes.
Bill yes, Paxton. The guy, one of the two guys.
The guy from Twister.
Sci-fi movies.
None of those are correct. None of those were correct. Only Michelle got them all right. That's amazing.
So excited. Wait, I didn't pick any.
Michelle knew all those. People Magazine's Sexiest Man Alive in the 90s. Gary Oldman, Brad Pitt, Harrison Ford.
Jeez. I know it's not one, but I'm not sure.
Yeah, there's one that I'm pretty sure it's not. And there's also one that I'm pretty sure it is. There's one I'm 100% sure it is. Brad Pitt and Harrison Ford are the correct answers. Oh, shit, son. Oh, Dane's almost out the door. No, 24 Chan overtakes Dane's body. 24 Grit, rather, overtakes Dane's body and gets out the door first. He wins.
Oh, man.
24 Chan?
I don't know why I said that. 24 Grit Jr. is the winner.
Well, you're thinking of 4chan.
Yeah, thanks.
I know, that's what I think.
That's sort of Michelle's fault from earlier.
God, I blew it again in the same goddamn place.
Are we doing? Let's do another one. Let's go again. Cool. Let's go again. I'm gonna hit play a sequel as soon as I cut segment.
Do we now become the third?
Yeah, I think so.
And Mike didn't survive the sequel.
Yeah, so I get to be Junior, the ones who died. Yeah, Trivia Murder Party 3, the exact same thing. I love that.
How the fuck did I screw up in the exact...
I don't know. Just getting categories that didn't favor you, I guess.
I feel like I'm the Buffalo Bills of Trivia Murder Party.
I think Question Trivia one. Murder Party profile...
Oh. Me and 24 Grader are Junior. Everybody else is the third. What a superhero parents' names are Martha and Thomas? Captain America, Superman, Spider-Man, or Batman?
Anybody that's never seen BVS will get angry.
Shut your face.
Yeah, no, I'm confused now.
I know what it is. I know the answer.
I know it's one, two. And
the correct answer is the Batman. Who got it
right? Batman.
Yeah.
Only Flossman got it wrong. Let's put Adam in the same situation as Batman's parents. Killing floor. Well, I mean, we'd have to take you to an alleyway first. Oh,
like
Flossman. We're gonna play memory, and everybody's playing. So, memorize the pattern on the screen.
My screen's black, so I can't even see it.
It's like the bottom half of the painting is all red, and then there's like it's like a bloody red thing with a red straw coming out of it.
Uh-huh.
That'll help you probably a little bit. I can't like exactly describe it to you because A, that wouldn't be fair, and B, I really can't. But hopefully that'll help you out a little.
Yeah, no, the stream kicked the button back on me.
If anybody does better than Adam, by the way, Adam does.
And then it's a weird straw thingy.
I mean, I've already said that, so she could just be repeating it.
And it's Layla. A smiley face.
That distracts me.
Here's that march again. All right. Let's see if you messed it up. Flossman got only... Oh, he missed it. Not he missed perfect. A row of reds, so he got 81% of it. I got bad news for you, Flossman. Four of us got 100%. Me, Dane, Bednarchik, and a 24 grit all got 100% of the painting, so... Flossman dies.
I think I did okay for not being able to see it.
Yeah, that one's hard to play without seeing the stream. It's lucky that a lot of the games in this game are not like that. I call it a scoreboard. Please don't feel bad for me. Let's move on to the next question, and the price is right. Question number two. Here we go. Oceania is the fictional world created by which author?
Oh, I know this one.
C.S. Lewis.
Movie.
C.S. Lewis, Catherine Patterson, George Orwell, Suzanne Collins.
I saw the movie a few weeks ago.
There was a movie?
Yeah.
It's funny that it's a fictional world because that's actually the name for the continent of Australia and its surrounding islands. That whole section is actually called Oceania.
Yeah, I used to have this globe, which you had this, like, pen that you'd touch to it, and you'd have to find locations.
It's George Orwell, by the way. Me, Michelle, and 24 Grade are going to the killing floor.
Oh, well, I finally got the screen work.
I didn't know it either.
Some of us know our Orwell.
Yeah.
A little too Orwell. All right, we're playing Drawn and Quartered.
You deserve to go to the
Oh, it's the drawing one.
This is the drawing one, yes. All right.
Time for me to...
All right, guys. Michelle, 24 Grit, and myself, draw moral ambiguity. Moral ambiguity. Draw that.
Type of podcast we do. Ascend when you're finished.
Silence. Shut your face. Scary noises.
Oh, somebody left. Who left?
I didn't leave.
Oh, Michelle left. Oh, shit. She better get her drawing in then.
She was too scared by my...
Alright, the drawings are in. Vote for the worst. Vote for the worst drawing. The one with the most votes dies.
Gee, I know. Got it.
The votes are in.
Votes are in. Three votes for B, three votes for C. Me and 24 Grit both die. Michelle actually survived that one. Congratulations, Michelle.
Without having to do anything.
Michelle? Michelle? Michelle?
Hello?
That might be why she's... Okay, that's why she's getting on and off, is because she's having mic issues.
She's dead, John.
No. That's impossible.
Really?
Anyway, yes. Yeah, me and 24 Grit died. Michelle lived. Again. Question three.
Ooh, here's a sexy one.
How many inches of floss should you floss with, according to the American Dental Hygienist Association?
Kamiyaba, do you know this one?
8 inches, 14 inches, 18 inches, or 24 inches? How many inches long is Flossman?
Gee, I don't know, because I live in Australia.
I was going to say, judging by the numbers there, no matter what you pick, I win.
Judging by some of the people in Australia, none of them floss.
Oh!
So, Billy, you're saying we're like British people?
What do you mean, some of the people?
They
didn't send them with floss when they went down.
Said some.
I didn't actually see the answer because I was busy dealing with the Discord. But Michelle and Billy missed it, so you're going to the killing floor. Worst answer is the category you're playing. Where do you see yourself in 5 years? Answer that question.
Like, the answer was 18 inches.
18 inches, okay.
Was it 18 inches? I thought it was 8.
Well, you're wrong, bitch.
Well, I underestimated my size.
But it's really thin, though. That's the problem.
Yeah. Mike, stop. Stop. Just.
Yeah.
Stop embarrassing me.
Stop embarrassing me.
Stop embarrassing me.
Stop embarrassing me.
Bopping. All
right.
I don't like
5 years older or humping. 5 years older, humping Asuka. Those are the two written answers. Pick the worst answer. The one with the most votes dies.
Well, this one's boring, so I'm gonna...
I know which one's which. That's the problem. You're not supposed to know which one's which, Billy.
Guys, that's stupid.
Oh. 3-2, 5 years older was voted worst answer, so Michelle dies.
I mean, no offense to Michelle, but I was looking for a little creativity.
So that would mean
humping Asuka is not that creative either.
You know.
So in five years, that would mean Michelle's able to.
That's all we hear Billy talk about. How much she wants to bang Asuka. Question four.
Who's left alive?
Dumb Starbucks was the brainchild of which comedian? Was it Ashton Kutcher, Sacha Baron Cohen, Nathan Fielder, or Tom Green?
Oh crap! I got out of it. Get back in.
As long as you have cookies enabled, you should be able to get back in.
Guys, that's...
Left Alive, by the way, is Dane, Bednarczyk, and Billy.
I'm dead.
I'm dead.
Nathan Fielder is the correct answer.
Yay!
All the Alive people got it right, so we're going to move right along.
Too easy. Okay. Yeah.
I have diabetes.
Can you speak now, Michelle? Yes, no?
The Magic Flute is an opera. I'll talk.
I guess not. The Magic Flute is an opera by which composer? Chopin, Beethoven, Bach, or Mozart?
That's an easy one.
If you don't get this, you're
The correct answer is Mozart. Billy missed it. He's going to the killing floor.
Billy, you're dumb.
You're such a stupid dummy dumb.
Right.
You're
Billy,
a dumb
Billy, you're playing math, as are the rest of us. You know how to do this. Answer as many math questions as you can before time runs out. Everybody else will be playing too. If anybody does better than Billy, he dies. Get on your marks, get set, and math, ladies and gentlemen, math.
Oh, doing math? Crap.
Hey, Michelle's back.
I'm mathing.
I'm mathing.
How am I frozen?
I'm Jerry Mathers.
Yeah, am I right? What?
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 You heard me. I'm the beaver.
I did. I just can't believe it. Jerry Mathers. Studio.
Oh, it's magic. Billy got 5. Literally everybody did better than Billy, so he dies.
Am I alive or dead? Because
Billy,
have no idea.
You know, Billy, when we have people play these games on the show, we expect them to at least, you know, try.
Billy's
tried. Really crappy at math.
I always knew he was dead.
For some reason, I didn't think you were that bad at math. Yeah, you're dead at this point, Michelle. You died during the wrong answer game. Question 6.
Let's mix things up. I always knew Billy was bad at math.
Study this photo. Remember as much as you can. I know. I'm sorry to anybody having stream issues.
Yeah.
I don't know why you guys are having stream issues. It should be running fine.
It says nan.
Yeah, that's what it did for me, and then it just crashed.
I mean, most of them were. So we don't know.
There's something wrong with your HTML5 codec, I guess. I don't know. What time does the cuckoo clock read? 8:10, 5, 11:40, 2:35. I'll be honest with you, I wasn't paying attention either, so.
I'm going to guess.
I'm going into this blind, too.
I think after this, depending on what we play, I might have to.
I think I know what it was.
It was 11:40.
Oops.
Oh.
Dane missed it, so he's going to the killing floor.
That was a good guess.
I did teeny, meeny, miny, this one.
Dane, you're playing fingers. Cut off a finger.
I need this one.
Yeah, Michelle, you actually got it right, believe it or not.
Dane always plays.
Dane picks off the first. Dane cuts off his index finger, so his first choice will be a finger for the rest of the game until he dies.
He's gonna.
If he dies. Bednarchik's actually in the lead at the moment.
He's gonna be a terrible.
Dane and Bednarchik are still alive. Question 7. Let's do this. Which landmark is located on Salisbury Plain? Is it Stonehenge, Eiffel Tower, Easter Island Heads, or Big Ben? I actually know the answer to this.
It's obviously steak.
Your name is Mike 24 Grit? Oh, okay. You're the boar guy from last time. Thanks for joining us again.
Salisbury.
Well, of course, it's the correct answer.
So you're Mike, and I'm Mike. Okay, so this thing I'm talking into will be Mike, so there's no confusion.
But what if the other Mike comes?
It's Stonehenge is the answer. Dane missed it, so he goes to killing floor.
Because it was a finger.
Yeah, this device I'm talking into will be Mike, so there's no confusion. Hey, Dane, you're going to play words. You're welcome, Mike. Spell the longest word you can before time runs out, Dane. Everybody else will be playing too, and if anybody spells a longer word than you, you die. Remember, the letters do not have to be connected. They just have to be there.
Word time, go.
Oh, can you not? Oh, you can click out.
I quit. I don't keep. I lost. Words.
Oh!
I'm so excited to see what you come up with.
Oh, right.
Dane. Dane has put in the word. Time is up. Never mind.
Oh, it just cut me off.
Dane put in magnet, which is 6 letters long, and that is a word, so it counts.
Magnet's a word?
Flossman,
oh, good lord.
Flossman put in goat, which is 4 letters. That's the only one I guess that was a word. I put in game hen. I thought that was a word. It would have been longer than Dane's, so whatever. But Dane lives.
I was trying to write namaste.
I was going to go. But namaste. Guys, following his death in 1822, Frankenstein author Mary Shelley carried around her dead husband's head, hand, heart, or left eye. Or Lisa Left Eye Lopez. The correct answer is heart. Yeah, Dane and Adam, the only two alive, got it right. So we're moving on. Question 9.
Matty knows his answer.
Heart. What's the correct pronunciation of the Vietnamese dish spelled P H O? Pho, pho, phu, or phê?
Jeez.
Oh, god damn it! The finger!
What?
So, go ahead and let's get your answer in there, Adam.
Alright, got it.
A lot of people would think it's pho, but it's not, it's pho.
Yep.
I know.
So if you come across the store that's called PHO King, it's actually fucking.
Get it?
Oh.
Yeah, it's actually pronounced pho. Dane and Adam go to the killing floor. You're playing arena, so you have to choose whether to attack, defend, or grab the money. Those are your choices. It's basically rock, paper, scissors. Do your shit, guys. Attack, defend, or grab the money.
Now
do it.
Go say hello to some people with your fists.
He said, go say hello to some people with your fists. All right. Dane and Adam both chose to attack.
Stab, stab, stab.
Adam dies. Oh, wait.
Some popcorn.
Adam and Dane both die. They both pick attack, so they both die.
Those cuts don't look serious.
I think Adam's going to be the one to
run. Whoever's in the lead is going to be the one that gets to run for their lives, though. Everybody's dead, unfortunately, but the person in the lead gets their life back.
Unfortunately. Whoa, Thank you, Mike, for that.
Adam, yes, Bednarczyk comes back to life because he's in the lead, so that means, Adam Bednarczyk, it's time for you to run for your life.
I won all the way to Washington.
All right. Let's see what happens here, because we're gonna do some shit.
Here's your first.
We're gonna do some shit to you.
Category number one, Academy Award for Best Original Song. Happy, Man or Muppet, You'll Be in My Heart.
Yeah.
Because I'm slappy.
Because
clap
I'm
along if you feel like a mood answers? Without a boob. Man or Muppet and You'll Be in My Heart are the correct answers. Alright, next.
I thought happy was.
Mushrooms. Maitake. Button. Shiitake. This one's an easy one. All three of them are correct. Me and Adam both knew that all three were correct. And the other Adam knew that the first two were correct. Months with 31 days. September, July, January.
That's pretty much.
Like, if you just do the 30 days half thing, you'll know exactly what the answer is. Yeah, September's the only one without 31 days there. July and January both have them. Everybody got all the answer, all the questions, all of them right, so. Alright. Next, New York City neighborhoods. Washington Heights, Soho, Tribeca. You know, some would say that this is a little slanted towards Dane.
Yeah, and if Washington Heights is one of them, that's the neighborhood I fucking live in here.
You would be surprised.
There's a lot of Washington Heights. There's a Washington Heights neighborhood in my area.
I know.
All three are correct, by the way.
Oh, are they?
Yeah. Ooh, Dane is two spaces behind Bednarczyk. Next category. Movies with talking animals. Shrek, Beverly Hills Chihuahua, Air Bud.
Oh, you gotta be kidding me.
That was easy.
That is. I mean, this is the dumbest question ever.
It's insanely easy if you just think about it for a second.
Once the Adam is outraged.
First of all, the dog never talks in Air Bud. Shrek and Beverly Hills Chihuahua. The answers. I think Dane's gonna overtake Bednarchuk here. Nope, not quite. He's a space behind. Is Dane gonna do to Bednarchuk what's been done to him twice? Foods you can eat on the paleo diet: avocado, eggs, potatoes. I don't know what that is, so I'm straight up guessing.
It's a stupid diet that's stupid.
They're all stupid diets. Just fucking lose weight. I mean, unless you're a lazy bastard like me, it's easy.
No, but this is the worst diet.
Avocado and eggs are the correct answer. Oh, Adam is so close to being out the door. Can Dane overtake him? Adam would literally have to miss all of this next category. States that border Tennessee. Pennsylvania, North Carolina, Missouri. I'm sorry that you got a USA question, Adam. This may fuck Adam Bednarchuk. And you know Dane's probably going to know it. And he's only two spaces behind you.
I'm a history major, not a geography major.
Shut up, bitch.
The only state there that does not border Tennessee is Pennsylvania. Adam actually got one of them right, so he gets out the door and lives. Adam Bednarchuk is the winner.
Jimmy Wiener!
Congratulations. Bednarchuk got out unscathed.
But I'm going to reference one of the Adam Sandler movies and Adoya Wolves!
Shut up.
What are we doing, guys?
I gotta go to the bathroom.
Well, I gotta take off, so, I will. 15,000 stolen. Horrific and entertaining.
So here's what I'll do, because I know there's a couple people that have to do that. So Dane, go ahead and go pee. I think Michelle said she had to get off the game in her browser and go to her mobile device, so I'll just do a new game. That way we're not like the, whatever our name is, the fourth, because that would be ridiculous.
Well, I have to take off anyway, so right. I'll talk to you guys later.
Have a good one, Flossie.
Yep.
Bye, cum yarper.
I was going to say, you mean cum yarper.
I will get you guys the new room code in just a moment.
Okay.
I'll be back.
Anyway, I will talk to you guys later.
Thanks. Have a good one.
Yep. Okay, you too. Bye.
Bye-bye.
All right.
All right, new room code.
New game?
Yeah, I'm starting a new game because Adam had to leave, and I wanted to give Dane time to go pee. And Michelle time to switch off to her mobile device.
Three straight games, I got second place. I really am the Buffalo Bills.
Goddamn. No, you're not the Buffalo Bills. The Buffalo Bills would be lucky to get second place.
Well, I mean, they were in the Super Bowl 4 years in a row, and they lost.
Oh. Well, you're not the Buffalo Bills yet, then. You have to get second in this game to do that.
Yet.
That is true.
All right, I'll switch over to the game screen now. I've got the code hidden. All right.
Because I'm slapping the
film. Clap along if your cheeks are kind of stuck together, too.
Because I
crappy. Crap what? Along if your name is Dollar Billy Carter.
Mud.
Mud.
Okay, time to enter the room.
This is a big mud.
Crap along if you feel.
Oh, yeah.
I feel ill.
Who is Granddad?
Granddad.
Is that you, Dane?
Yes.
Oh, okay.
Granddad.
Granddad.
I am.
Yes, sir.
Michelle is typing. Trying to find my phone charger. Okay, it's fine. So, while we're in this lull here, and I'm not actually, because I cut segment. So, in case you're not following the MVG Live page on Facebook, you should. It's facebook.com/MVGLive. That's where all the upcoming events are. Next week, when we return to being just MVG Live, and by the way, next month marks 4 years since we started doing MVG Live, so there you go. Yay! And we will be celebrating that. Well, first of all, next Wednesday, we're going to do something Mark really wanted to see. Yes, I'm aware you can't see the room code yet. I will unveil it in a moment. Actually, fuck it, because, like, there's not enough people to fill the room, so there you go. Fuck, what was I going to say? Oh, next week we're going to play something that Mark has been wanting to finish up, and we're gonna finish up where in the USA is Carmen Sandiego. We started that a couple weeks ago after finishing or playing Heretic, which we did not finish that game, but that's all right. But yeah, we started playing Where in the USA is Carmen Sandiego, and we're going to finish that on stream next week. Then, to celebrate 4 years, I'm going to go back to the old days. Back in the early era, before I was able to record the streams, I actually played the second Donkey Kong Country game. I played that game also again, and I beat it too, 102%. And then I played the game again last summer and beat it again. Only got 101%, but I figured out what the other 1% was, is because I never visited Cranky Kong. You have to visit each of the Kongs to get a percent. So if I had just visited Cranky Kong, I would have had 102%. So I'm going to call that one a completion as well. Because I got everything else in the game. So, this time, to celebrate, we're going to play, in 2 weeks, we're going to play an often overlooked and underrated SNES classic from 1996 that was overshadowed by the N64, and we're going to play ourselves Donkey Kong Country 3, Dixie Kong's Double Trouble. And that will be 2 weeks from tonight. 3 weeks from tonight, we're going to take a break from DKC, and we're going to do something a little different. 3 weeks from tonight, on November 16th, which is the week before Survivor Series, WWE's Survivor Series event, who is Weenie Hut?
Not me.
Weenie Hut Jr.
Oh, that's Michelle. Okay.
Hi.
Hey. Hey, Michelle. Glad to hear your voice again.
I know I'm going to lose the first one, so that way then I'll be Weenie Hut Jr.
Hey, look, that's Michelle, cool. Look who's in the game. Granddad.
But anyway, in 3 weeks, 3 weeks from tonight, on the 16th of November, we're going to play, we're going to do something a little special. It'll be a special edition of MVG Live where I am in the process of creating avatars of everybody in the, on mental stuff or on Culture Shock stuff. I'm creating all of you in SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. We're going to simulate a pay-per-view and call it Autumn Altercation. So, if you're basically everybody on the call right now will be in the game. A couple of you have already been created.
Bad phone.
You, I'm going to create a bunch of like 30 people, maybe 32 because that's how many it supports. And we're just going to simulate a pay-per-view called Autumn Altercation using SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. We actually did this a couple years ago on Geek Juice Gaming Live using WWF No Mercy, but I figured it was time for an upgrade. 3 weeks from tonight, 3 weeks, 4 weeks from tonight is the 23rd of November. And we're going to do a two-night special event that week because the 23rd is the normal day of the week. And we're gonna play Donkey Kong Country 3 again. We're going to continue it. But we're also going to play it on the next night, November 24th. And the reason for that, I know it's Thanksgiving, but that is also my birthday. So we're going to be playing it then as well. So we're going to do a special. I am planning to do a special Thursday show in advance this time. So, yeah, I know it's Thanksgiving, but it's also my birthday, so I'm hoping some people will drop by to help me celebrate my 32nd birthday.
I probably will. If it's after everybody eats and
calls. Yeah, it'll be far after everybody's had dinner, so...
Well, that'll be fine.
So it'll be normal time, about 10 Eastern. So, yeah, come help me celebrate my birthday on that day as well. That'd be great. I would love to have you. It'd be fantastic. All right, let's hit start record and do this. Back on MVG Live, dead, whatever, middle ground. 7-person game. From left to right, the purple minion is Ricardo. The red angry dude is Billy. The green thing with the rope around him is Bednarczyk. The orange Patrick is me. The gray sack is 24 grit. The yellow squid is Dane. And the pink voodoo doll is Michelle.
For those of you who are wondering where I got Gram Bam from...
Oh, dear goodness.
Watch the... YouTube channel Vine Sauce, the guy named
Vine Sauce. Vine Sauce is where I got. Vine Sauce is where I got. Thanks for checking in. I'm still a piece of garbage.
And listen to Joel. There's actually a video called Vine Sauce Joel Granddad. You'll get right the reference.
Question one.
Granddad.
Question one coming up. What occupation does Charlie Brown's dad hold? Is it?
They actually have parents?
A barber, an architect, a carpenter, or a school teacher? No, they have parents. They just go wah 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 wah.
Oh! I know this. Because it was actually a joke in all the early scripts.
He's a barber. He's a barber, guys, which is funny because Charlie Brown's bald. But Ricardo and Michelle missed it. They go to the killing floor.
They're actually not bald per se.
Yes, little hair.
Yes, some hair.
He has a little hair, yeah. Like 2 or 3. Hey, Ricardo and Michelle, you two are playing decisions. If you take the money, he will kill everyone who did not take the money, and if you all take the money, you will all die. So make the decision carefully, you two.
Looking at you, Ricardo. And listen.
Don't be a dick. Don't be a dick. Michelle was the dick, and Ricardo is dead.
You know, Michelle, I'm not even angry.
I'm not angry.
I'm just disappointed.
I think it's hilarious. Good job, Michelle.
He said not to be a dick, and my name's Weenie Hut.
Oh, fair enough. You know what? She's got me on that one. I'm sorry, Dane. She's got me.
Weenie Hut Jr.
To be fair, I am Weenie Hut. Let's
try this again. I am Weenie.
Question two. We all need our boundaries. What mountain range separates France from Spain? Is it the Carpathians, the Pyrenees, the Alps, or the Caucasus?
The Caucasus?
That is not a mountain range.
It is a range, but it's not a mountain range.
Ricardo didn't take the money because he said he only takes jobs.
Oh.
No, that's it. The stream's over.
Pyrenees is the correct answer. Billy and Michelle missed it. They're going to the killing floor.
Do I hear another one where I get to murder Ricardo?
No, you're going to murder Billy this time, probably. Or he's going to kill himself by coughing himself to death.
Got Ebola.
Oh, God, Ebola. You two are playing patterns. Oh, no. Oh, okay, it's the card patterns. Green grenade, blue gun, blue hammer, green grenade. That's the pattern. Keep it in your mind.
Do.
Are we all playing this or no?
Just Billy and Michelle.
This is how I play Simon.
What was the order of colors? Order of colors from left to right. Order colors from left to right. Let's see. It was green, blue, blue, green. Michelle got it all right. Billy dies.
Yeah.
Michelle's a murderer. Michelle is a goddamn.
Yeah, Michelle, you've killed two people now. How do you feel?
How do you feel?
I had never felt so alive. Like, her fucking outfit's just covered in other people's blood. And...
It's American Psycho 2.
Yep. Here's that scoreboard again. The most unassuming psycho killer ever.
I just imagine Michelle being like, you ever listen to Huey Lewis?
Are you wearing your Kyo costume while you do this? How many waterfalls
make up Niagara Falls?
Sorry, how many waterfalls make up Niagara Falls? One, two, three, or four?
I declare some more.
Are you
she is Saris. She is Saris, after all. But no, she's Kyo, because Kyo's the one that carries the scissors around, right?
That's a show.
Oh.
Genocider show.
That's it.
Oh, that's disgusting.
So that makes more sense. Like, Saris, you just blow a hole in somebody because of the bazooka. I know some things about anime. Three is the correct answer, by the way. Me and 24 Grit go to the killing floor.
Let's go someplace fun.
Murder each other. I mean, what?
Yeah, Michelle's not going to get to kill either of us. Drawn? Uh-oh, it's drawn and quartered.
Which means I do get to be responsible for killing one of you.
Draw a nice way to die, 24 Grit. Mike.
I think we should blow up all of Michelle's porcelain cats. Huh? What? What?
Pander, people. Pander.
Pandering!
Pandering.
Pandering makes the world go round.
Pandering is why we don't play Quiplash.
Pandering.
Pandering is
why we can't.
You
can't really pander in that one because the questions are all also about us.
Yeah, but we just need to say yes, nut.
Oh, I've been informed that the Caucasus Mountain Range is in Russia. I just thought it was something that people like, something that, like a survey or something. Hurry,
yeah, I
Mike.
I thought it was like a census.
Hurry, Grit. Hurry.
Go.
Do.
Five,
I hope you're not taking
four,
the fact that I
three,
asked you to pander me seriously.
Two, one. He got in, just barely. Alright, so somebody wrote, number A is just, it says Michelle, and number P is a noose. So pick the worst drawing.
I'm sorry.
Most votes is the loser. Sorry. The most votes is gets killed, by the way. Everybody's in, the votes are 3-2 in favor of the Michelle drawing. Well, I tried. I died.
Overrated.
It's worth a shot.
Michelle, you're responsible.
Yeah, technically, Michelle's responsible for my death.
I should probably get crazy for drawing somewhere.
So I still get. She ended up getting the satisfaction.
Next.
Worst part is because I voted for the noose.
Right now, Michelle's in the lead, by the way.
Because it gives me bonus money for surviving.
Question four. Pluto may no longer be a planet, but in Roman mythology, he's the god of punishment, the night, war, or the underworld. Grit says, I actually want a drawing. I need to call Ripley. Yeah, it's funny, too, because I used to draw a comic strip when I was in high school. So I have a lot of experience in it. The underworld is the correct answer. All the alive people got it right, so congratulations. We move on.
He rules the underworld.
Question five. Which of these is an ampersand? Is it the first choice, the second choice, the third choice, or the fourth choice? Which of those is an ampersand?
All you English majors know this.
Actually, I know this because of Family Guy.
Mm-hmm.
Oh, is that right?
So the first one's the ampersand. The second one is a euro symbol. The fourth one is a carrot. And the third one is the at symbol, or as we've lovingly renamed it on the Mentalcast, the McCorkle.
The McCorkle!
Dane Bednarczyk, Grit, and Michelle went to the killing floor, and you're playing Greed.
Because we all got it right.
Yeah, you're playing Greed. No, you all got it wrong.
No!
No, we all got it right.
Said we got it right. What the hell?
Oh.
Everyone got it right.
Everyone got it right, so yeah. So he was tired of waiting, so y'all went to killing floor. Take the most or the least money, and you will be punished. You have to enter a number between, I believe it's 0 and 1,000.
Yep.
Okay.
So. You know, I wonder what happens if you enter 0 or 1,000 if the guy
then
makes
you die.
Commentary.
Then
I know,
you die.
He makes commentary about it.
You're a jackwagon.
I got bad news. I got bad news for Dane and for Bednarczyk. You guys die.
$1 bomb?
Dane picked $175 and Adam picked $6.16, and those were the least and the most, respectively. So, Dane actually died early. Or not early, early, but, you know. Michelle and Grit are still alive, so we keep going.
I am not speaking to Michelle for the rest of the,
That's not true. Hey, question six. Seriously. What the hell is polenta? Is it...
Oh, I know this one.
Cornmeal mush, rice mush, oatmeal mush, or eggplant mush? Well, we know it's mush. Of some sort.
I have no idea. I'm gonna do any, mini, miny, this one.
Trying to think.
The correct answer is cornmeal mush.
Oh, I was gonna guess either that one.
The bad news though is that Michelle Grit got it right, so you're going to the killing floor by yourself.
Yeah, well, I've survived two, three of these.
I got bad news for you. You're playing loser wheel.
I survived two or three of these, so maybe the game's gonna be like, hey, let's survive another one for you.
Maybe.
Death. Sorry. That means 24 Grit is the only one left alive, so 24 Grit, it's time to run for your life. By the way, Grit is in like fourth place, just so you know.
Oh shit.
So even though he's the only one left alive, there's still three better scores than him, including the one he just killed, Michelle.
Jesus.
Here we go. First category is, and it's for everybody, remember, noble gases, xenon, neon, propane. Billy Carter's ass farts is not an answer. There's nothing noble about that gas.
I pick propane and propane accessories.
Oh god, propane and propane accessories. Xenon and neon. Xenon and neon are the correct answers.
Hey, where you those two kids will
whacking off in my tool shed? No, he wanted butane and butane accessories. Hostess snack cake products, honey buns, zoinks, or fudge roundies. Or all of them or none of them, actually.
Son of a man.
Honey buns, zoinks, fudge roundies.
Like zoinks, man.
Like zoinks, Scoob. I just realized something. Scooby Dooby. Honey buns is the only answer. Correct answer there.
God, Grit is way out of luck.
Ivy League schools. College of William and Mary. Harvard University. Cornell University.
Harvard.
It's like there's one of those that I'm 100% sure is. It's the most famous one. Practically.
Yes, indeed.
And I'm pretty sure there's one other. Yeah, Harvard and Cornell are the correct answers there.
William and Mary, well, a very good college. Not
yeah, no, not an Ivy League school. All right, here we go. Next category is sriracha ingredients. Chili, distilled vinegar, sugar. I love sriracha. It's really spicy, but I fucking love the stuff.
I used to work with it all the time. It's really difficult to wash out of things. It's horrendous.
Oh, it's so good though. They're all three the correct answer.
Obvious meal.
Next, original Mighty Morphin Power Rangers. Yellow Ranger, Black Ranger, Maroon Ranger.
Oh, this is not even fair anymore.
Hey, you want to know what's funny? The Yellow Ranger.
Yellow and black are correct. Everybody got all of them right, so that's like not a surprise.
Lately in the seasons, there actually has been a Maroon Ranger.
Next, red wine, Riesling, Sauvignon Blanc, Shiraz.
Oh,
I mean, the name of one of these gives away that it's not.
Sauvignon Blanc.
Shut up, Bill.
Yeah, just say it out loud so that everybody gets their leg up. Shiraz is the only one. Sauvignon Blanc. Blanc is white in French, so like that's obviously not red. Dane is getting like really close to catching up with Grit. Ernest films. Ernest Scared Stupid. Ernest Saves Christmas. Ernest Gets Married.
Sorry, folks.
Yeah, Dane's probably got this one. He's up on the Ernest movies.
I know this one too.
I do too, actually.
Actually, Grit is really seriously right by the door.
Scared Stupid and Saves Christmas are the correct answers. Dane has caught up with Grit and taken over his body.
Oh shit. I thought Grit would...
No, he's not out the door. Professional sports teams from New York State. Islanders, Sharks, Giants. We're fucked. We're done. We're done. No, we're done.
It's
bullshit.
We're fucking done. We're fucking done, man. I'm fucking done.
Yeah, no.
Islanders,
Islanders
and Giants. Dane wins. Dane fucking wins.
I think Chiffia murder party's cheating.
That was fucking bullshit. Although I will say though, after three games in a row of you getting shafted, that was probably sweet victory for you.
Okay.
You're not the Buffalo Bills.
Oh, good.
You're not the Buffalo Bills. You won one.
I actually won something. My God.
Okay. Dad survives.
Question. Another game of this? Or Quiplash 2 or Guesspionage?
What's Guesspionage?
Quiplash. I know a couple of you haven't played Guesspionage yet. Hold on. Here's what I'll do. I will take a poll. Let me get a poll written.
Hang on, let me play.
Are you putting this poll up your butt?
No, I'm putting it on straw poll.
While we wait, I'm gonna play the granddad.
Oh my God, yes, please do. I'm gonna play Fire Emblem and listen to this.
Granddad! Flintstones! Granddad! What the fuck? Granddad!
Alright, so there's the straw poll. I'm putting it in the chat now and in the Discord.
Oh my God.
Vote now. Vote on which game you want to see.
Joel is the fucking best.
That we should play next.
So she's screaming out loud.
Have you ever considered friendship?
Here comes the friendship.
You know what? I'm going to pick this one. And oh, let's me pick two. No, I can't pick two.
I'm kicking now.
Oh, this is interesting. I guess Layla's in trouble.
Has everybody? I'm seeing four votes.
Picking one now.
I'm gonna see if I can vote twice.
Oh hey, what the fuck? Oh, five votes. I thought somebody did not.
Five votes. I think there's. Yeah, there's five. There's four of us on the call and one in the chat and two in the chat, actually. So there should be six votes.
I haven't voted yet. I don't know what.
Yeah, no, it won't let me vote twice.
I fucking.
If we end up playing Guesspionage, I'll explain what it is. It's Family Feud crossed with Card Sharks. It's actually quite a lot of fun, depending on the questions we get. We had actually a lot of fun playing it last night.
I think everybody's in,
and the votes are in. 4-2-0. It looks like we're playing Quiplash 2 next.
Joel, if you're ever listening to this, you're a fucking amazing dude. Joel from Mind's Boss. Gram bam!
I love his videos of him destroying, like, computer systems, getting all the viruses. I know what I'm making my next name.
Okay, we're gonna play Quiplash 2 right after this.
What's your name gonna be, Michelle?
Either if I can spell it, expand dong.
Or
Bouncy Buddy.
Bouncy Buddy. Let's see if I actually
We're just gonna play with in-game prompts. Because I think we've exhausted pretty much all of the MVG Live pack prompts.
I've only played the MVG pack once.
I mean, we can play it again if you want, but I think the rest of us have seen all the questions.
They're great.
What's the room?
I have not made it yet. Hold on. I'll tell you what. I'll go ahead. We'll play one round of that. And if we come back to Quiplash 2 the next time, we'll play...
I haven't seen this, and I get all the memes from it, but I don't get to see it, and then I feel sad.
It's okay. No, it's fine.
I'm a sad Shelly.
I'm just gonna say it, because it was, like I said, that it's not gonna fill up the room or anything. WFKT is the room code.
Did you remember to enter your room first?
Yeah, I'm in there.
You better go.
Who's Bonsai Buddy? Is that Adam?
Sorry, I'm back. What was the code?
WFKT. Who is Bonsai Buddy then?
Michelle.
Yeah, I told you that was my name.
Dane's granddad with an exclamation mark.
Granddad!
Solidus Snake? Who is that? I'm guessing that's probably Grit, actually.
Yep.
Alright.
Oh, where did my thingy go? Stupid
Quiplash. Alright, let's play a game of Quiplash 2. We are playing the MVG Live Pack.
Plastic screen, where are you?
Quiplash 2 was voted to be the next thing we played. We will play a game of Guesspionage after this as well. Because I do want you guys to experience at least one game of that. Because it is actually kind of fun. Like, Dane, I know, has said he doesn't think it's that great. He thinks it's fine, but he doesn't think it's that great. I think I like it. And a lot of people played it last night like it, too. So we'll see what happens.
To be fair, last night it was actually a really interesting game.
We had some really good questions last night, so maybe we'll get some good questions this night, too. All right, round one. Round one. Fight. Each answer will go up against I was gonna say, sing any other theme from Street Fighter. That was Vegas theme, by the way. I'm in. 65 seconds. Rhythmic says, I like it because I win a lot. Yeah, I don't think Ricardo's lost a game of Guesspionage yet.
Guesspionage champion.
Mike, I'm super excited because I'm working on a cosplay for a really big convention.
Yeah?
And it's actually Street Fighter related.
Oh?
The day that I graced your convention seemed to be the greatest day of your life. But for me, it was a weekend.
Something that will happen on the last episode of the Mentalcast. Choppy choppy Bill's pee-pee, or a woman got stuck inside a man stuck inside a cow.
I do.
I don't like that top one.
I like that top one.
I like that top one.
3-2 in favor of the woman and the man and the cow. 700 points to Michelle, 400 to me. You like choppy choppy your pee-pee?
No, I don't want the choppy choppy my pee-pee.
Something Michelle Light could say in her kid voice that wouldn't be creepy. I want everything beaches, or that was so bad.
I want everything beaches. That was so bad.
Well, they were both equally creepy, so
I forgot to vote because I was too busy reading them.
3-1 in favor of I want everything beaches. 850 to Adam. 850 to Ben. Well, I guess I could just call him Adam now. 850 to Adam. 250 to Mike in the chat. Make up the title of the next Breaklight Religion song. I'm a fucking tree, or oops, she was 12. Excuse me. Fucking excuse me.
Oops,
no, you know what? No, actually, I'm gonna do this.
Shut the hole, dude.
I think. Oh, I don't think I did it quick enough. 2-2 tie. So 500 points apiece to Ricardo and Billy. I actually hit the censor button on Oops, She Was 12, but it didn't take, so. Where's Chelsea Tarkin's dog Finley will poop next? Next to Layla, she will be blamed, or on my soul?
I have a one, it's possible.
Oops, she was 12.
3-2 in favor of on my soul. 700 for me, 400 to Dane. Next question. An idea for an improv game that would never fly on You Can't Be Serious. Pants off, dance off, or smell my buttocks? Yeah, especially Bill's playing that one. Yeah, or either of them, actually.
Excel at that game.
Knowing Bill, he would play both of these combined. 3-2 in favor of smell my buttocks. 700 points to Adam, 400 to Michelle.
Smell my buttocks.
Smell my buttocks.
Next. Things being an extra in an Adam Sandler movie can't buy you your dignity or happiness.
Can't buy me.
Oh. This one hits you right in the feels.
Well, it would hit Jason in the feels if he was here.
I feel secondhand feels.
Fair enough. 3-2 in favor of your dignity. 700 points to Grit, 400 to Ricardo. Moving on. Next up, a mental news story you wish would happen. Asuka loves Bill or peas in the Middle East.
Billy, that reminds me, I have to send you a picture of a shirt that I got gifted. One of my friends gifted me an Asuka shirt.
5-0 in favor of peas in the Middle East. 1250 in the Quiplash to Dane. Nicely done.
Who's the other person?
Billy. Of course. I think you could have figured that out.
Let's check the scoreboard.
Top three are Dane, Adam, and me and Michelle are tied for third.
God damn it, Mike!
We are number three.
See, it put me in fourth.
Both of my prompts were about the same person. That's great. Me, Adam, and Mike are in. 50 seconds. Ricardo's in. 45 seconds. Dane is in. Michelle is in. 35 seconds. Billy's in. Let's do it.
Okay, here we go.
All right, let's have a look.
First prompt.
First one.
A place where even Billy Carter wouldn't fart. On his own head or Asuka's House of Pain?
Use your device to pick your favorite.
Well, I know my answer.
Wouldn't and couldn't are two different things.
I couldn't. I just couldn't.
Well, if you can't fart somewhere, then you wouldn't fart there. Now, would you, by default? Four to one in favor of Asuka's House of Pain. 1,800 points to Adam, 400 to me. So I guess Billy would fart on his own head. What series is Asuka from? No, it's a wrestler. WWE wrestler.
It's Billy's waifu.
What Dane Ford Jones' next impression will be? John Oliver or Granddad?
Granddad!
Yeah, Asuka is the NXT Women's Champion right now in WWE.
John Oliver is just me doing a British accent. Hey, I'm John Oliver.
4-1 in favor of Granddad. 1,800 to Ricardo, 400 to Adam.
Next.
Granddad.
The next professional wrestler to block Rick Taurasi will be time. Dizzy Gillespie or Chris Benoit. Oh, wait.
It's
Chris Benoit.
I know there's no T.
Well, there's no anything anymore.
Well,
he died 10 years ago. 3-2 in favor of Jizzy Gillespie. 1,400 to Ricardo, 600 to Dane.
Jizzy Gillespie.
Jizzy Gillespie.
Okay, well,
the next Oscar-worthy Daniel Day-Lewis performance: Dane Ford Giona's granddad or Daniel Day-Lewis?
Granddad.
Say Daniel Day-Lewis will play Dane Ford Giona playing granddad.
Lynch?
4-1 in favor of Dane Ford Jones' granddad. 1,800 to Dane, 400 to Michelle.
I don't know who Daniel Day-Lewis is.
He played Abraham Lincoln. Michael Riley would be shocked to see blank in GeoGuessr. Boobs or me? Depending on who wrote these, this could be the same thing.
Well, let's say I wrote boobs. Would you be surprised?
Well, Michelle wrote boobs. 3-2 in favor of boobs. So, 1,400 to Michelle, 800 to Mike in the chat. I wouldn't be shocked to see that. That'd be normal for me. A can of soda Michael Riley would never drink. Cosby juice or cum AIDS? Excuse me.
Not only do you have AIDS, you have cum AIDS. Oh, that was it. That's it for Michelle. She was totally.
Cosby juice is the winner. 1400 to Mike, 600 to Billy, 800 to Billy, rather.
Okay, yes.
The next big toy to be reviewed by Billy Carter, Pickle Joe Moe or a gold dildus?
Pickle Joe
Moe. I don't know what that means.
I don't know what it means either.
Welcome back, Michelle.
Sounds like a wing puff of a Cotton Eye Joe.
41 in favor of Pickle Joe Moe. 1800 to Billy, 400 to me. Michelle, at least Michelle voted for mine.
That's all for round two.
Aww, act like I care.
But you voted for the dildos.
Whoa.
Top three after round two are Dane, Ricardo, and Adam. Boobs always win. Yeah, you're right about that, Ricardo. Boobs always win.
It's round three.
No, Granddad's been taking it lately.
Really? In the game, or... Let's play Last Lash. Acro Lash. So it's an acronym. Make up a phrase that starts with this, that fits this acronym. C-A-L. There we go. Myself and Michelle are in 40 seconds. Adam's in.
Yeah, no, Billy, I actually got gifted an Otsuka t-shirt, which is actually like really, really big on me, so I use it as a pajama shirt.
Can I lick it?
Not when she's wearing it, Bill. That's gross.
Oh, no, not when she's wearing it, no.
It's still gross. 10 seconds, 9, 8, 7, 6. Who's not in? 5, 4, 3, 2. Somebody's not in. It's over. Oh, Ricardo barely got in, like under the wire.
Yay,
holy
Ricardo.
Shit. Alright. CAL, what's it stand for? Carlos Alfonso Labatone? Caustic ass leakage. Cox at L. Carter's Oscar's Lady. Chronic asshole liquor, Carter Oscar love, or Cum Yarper's awesome lube,
or as it says, Croic. Croic,
yeah.
Sounds like an infomercial brand for Flossman. Hey, you can get Cum Yarper's awesome lube for the extra price of $9.99.
Time ran out, Rizmix, but your answer is still up there, so you got in just in the, you literally put it in as it was hitting zero, so you got in.
I'm wondering who Carlos friggin' Nabatone is. Is that a drug dealer?
I don't know. Time's about up. Time is up. Alright.
Nice, let's see who snagged the medals.
Alright, medals are being distributed. Bronze, yep. Silver, and gold.
Mm.
Oh, I got a lot of gold medals, apparently. 500 points to Billy. 2,000 to Michelle, Ricardo, and Mike. 2,500 to Dane. 3,000 to me. Adam Bednarczyk gets 3,500 points in the win for Cum Yarper's Awesome Lube.
Okay, let's see those.
Was it really a contest?
So, the winner of the game.
It's gonna be
Ozzy
Adam.
It's gonna be
Ozzy
Adam.
It's gonna be me.
Ow.
Bye.
No contest. Adam wins. We're gonna move on to Guesspionage right after this. Stay tuned. Alright, let me set up the Guesspionage and I'll get you a room code real quick.
I need to come up with a new name now.
Yes.
I'm gonna set up this game.
Why?
I have a doctor's appointment at 10 o'clock in the morning.
Oh, okay. That's fair. I feel like the hesitation on that makes me feel like you made that up. Just
no,
to get
I
out
do.
Of playing Guess Me
Not.
I have a doctor's appointment. I can't play Guess Me Not.
What kind of doctor's appointment, Bill? Gynecologist.
It's actually my therapist.
Aww.
I'll take the rapist.
Hugs, Billy.
All right, I'm just gonna leave.
See you guys later.
Have a good night, Bill. I'm just gonna leave the room code open. It's NIHX. NIHX. Granddad rules.
He does.
I forgot the Michelle is expandong.
I got it.
Is that when did Joel say that?
In his Windows XP one in the same episode with his dad, like
Adam Bednar.
You've been
Influence.
You've been drawn dicks. Who's been drawn dicks?
Mike in the chat left too. Oh, Ricardo's still there though. Alright, so there's five of us, so I think we're just gonna do that. Cool.
I'm gonna be the bald eagle named Expandong.
Alright, guys, we're getting ready to play Guesspionage. Have you all selected your agent? Yes, you have all selected your agent. Everybody's in, let's do it.
3, 2, 1.
So I explained to Michelle that it's a cross between Family Feud and Card Sharks. She's probably never seen either of those shows because they were way before her time.
I was on Family Feud.
Really?
Can you believe the cosplay version?
Oh.
I was Princess Peach and my husband was the Emperor from Star Wars.
We're playing Guesspionage, la 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 lee lee loo.
And isn't Card Sharks that one where you need to get 21?
No. It's higher or lower, yeah. I'm starting. So I'm starting this round. The first category for me is sandwich crusts. Alright. Question is, what percentage of people regularly cut off or avoid eating the crusts on their sandwiches? I'm going to enter a percentage that I think the answer is. I'm selecting 38%. The rest of you need to decide whether the actual answer is higher or lower than that.
I like the crusts.
What happens if you happen to guess the exact amount, though?
Then I'm the only one that would get points, and I would get 3,000 points. Dane went up higher, everybody else went lower. The correct answer is 13%. Wow. I was way off. That's a 25% difference. I get 300 points. Adam, Michelle, and Ricardo get 1,000 points.
I seriously love my name and my icon, Expandong the Bald Eagle.
All right, Adam is up next. Adam, the category for your question is condoms.
Goody.
Why can't I get this one?
What percentage of people right now have condoms in their homes?
Try to think. I got it. All right, this is a joke. I'm pressing it anyway.
69%. Everyone higher or lower? Well played, Adam. Higher or lower than everybody else. You cheeky bastard. Michelle thinks it's higher, everybody else thinks it's lower. The correct answer is 52%. So actually, Adam was not far off. It's earning interest. He was only 17% off. He gets 700 points. Me, Ricardo, and Dane get 1,000 points. I've got some
points for you. Remember, kids, safe sex.
Safe sex, yes, indeed. Who's next? All right, Michelle's up next. And Michelle's category is... All right, buckle in. I've got one for you. Spoilers. What percentage of people can stop themselves from reading movie or TV spoilers when seeing spoiler alert warnings?
Oh.
By the way, anybody who was watching the stream and paying attention, you saw them give away the answer to this question.
Spoilers!
Yeah.
Yeah, thanks.
Oh, no!
Come on, let me tune it to the number.
You know, even Entertainment Weekly's blog, you died.
23%? Higher or lower than that?
Even Entertainment Weekly magazine spoiled Who Died on Walking Dead.
Me and Adam picked higher, Ricardo and Dane picked lower. It was actually 76%, so they didn't spoil it.
53% and buy the cover of the magazine, unless.
53% difference. Only me and Adam got points on that one, and we get 1,000 points each.
That's mean. They said the answer was 23.
They did say that. Ricardo's next, and his category is rotten food. Okay. Question. What percentage of people have at least one expired item in the fridge right now?
Ooh, Ricardo.
Ooh, Ricardo.
I'm really bad at
62%? Higher or lower than that?
Higher or lower.
Everybody said lower. Let's see the correct answer. 82%!
Only I really think that'd be something that people would admit.
20% difference. Ricardo gets 550 points, and that's it. Because nobody else, everybody else said lower. Wow.
I'm bombing this game.
Alright, Dane is up next, and his category is...
data about everything, even this.
Peanut butter and jelly.
Peanut butter jelly time,
What percentage of people regularly purchase peanut butter and jelly packed together in one jar?
Ew.
Don't say ew.
Some people
I like peanut butter and jelly, but I don't like it when it's in the same jar because, like, my oldest brother likes...
You're going to put it together on the sandwich anyway. What's the matter?
My oldest brother likes strawberry and I like grape. And I don't want him to not be able to eat the peanut butter because it's mostly packaged up in,
45% is what Dane said.
It's slightly higher.
Adam and Michelle picked higher. Ricardo and I picked lower. The correct answer is... 3%!
The Bible prohibits wearing clothing of two
woven fabrics. With my gut.
So that's a 42% difference, so Dane's not going to get any points. Me and Ricardo do get 1,000 points each.
You get points.
Fuck.
Yeah, no, like, the fact that my brother likes strawberry and I like grape jelly, and if the jellies...
At the end of round one.
You can't have the jellies.
At the end of round one, fifth place. In fourth place, tied for fourth is Michelle and Dane. In third is Adam. Second is me. First is Ricardo. Is that any surprise? Round two. All right, round two, you can double up on the answers, by the way, and I'll explain in a minute. I'm first up, and my category is...
Well, here's one we've been especially interested in. Don't ask why.
Dryer sheets. Question. Mm. What percentage of people regularly use dryer sheets?
Oh, it's cold.
Gonna give me the dial so I can choose an answer. Thank you. There we go. I'm picking 60%.
In round two,
you can go higher or lower, or if you think the answer is off by more than 15%, you can go much higher or much lower. Make your selections now. Adam says higher, Michelle says much higher, Dane says lower, and Ricardo says lower. Let's see the correct answer.
Let's see the right answer.
65%!
Excellent.
5% difference. I get 2,500 points. Adam gets 1,000 points. But unfortunately, Michelle, it was within the 15% threshold, so you get no points.
Yeah, whatever.
Man, I just can't catch a break in this game.
I know, right?
Adam is next. Category for him is toothbrushes.
Toothbrushes.
What percentage of people use electric toothbrushes?
Wait a minute.
43% is what Adam says. Is the actual answer higher or lower than that? It's tough.
This is tough.
Me, Michelle, and Dane went higher. Ricardo went lower. The correct answer is 38%. Nice guess, Adam. 5% off, 2,500 points to Adam. Ricardo gets 1,000 points. Yeah, that is a we got that. We had that question before. I couldn't remember the percentage though.
Who's next?
Michelle's up next. Category for her is...
I'm going to search for...
burping.
Weddings.
Or weddings and excuses.
What percentage of people have cried at weddings other than their own?
Hmm.
72%, says Michelle.
What do you think?
Higher or lower? I've gone much lower. Ricardo and Dane went lower. Okay, Adam went higher. The correct answer, 40%.
The worst people cry at green card weddings. Yes, it happens.
32% difference. No points for Michelle. 1,000 points to Ricardo and Dane. 2,000 to me because I went much lower.
Well done. Double points for saying much lower.
All right, I'm coming after you, Ricardo. Ricardo's next up, and his category is...
Typey.
Fanny packs. Question. What percentage of people have worn fanny packs? Fanny packs? I don't know what that is.
Fanta packs.
Okay, Ricardo is saying 31%.
Everyone else, higher or lower?
Higher or lower than that?
I used to wear one when I went to school.
Adam and Dane went higher. Me and Michelle went much higher. The correct answer is 65%.
I'm telling you, they're gonna make a comeback.
Good.
34% difference. No points for Ricardo. 1,000 points to Adam and Dane. 2,000 points to me and Michelle. When I was a kid, I used them, says Ricardo. Yep. Dane's up. His category is?
I don't know. How about...
Lunar landing. What percentage of people believe the moon landings were faked?
Oh, gosh.
I wonder...
I was going to say, really? You're going to go all the way down? What are you doing? Dane, what are you doing?
Nothing.
I'm gonna pick 100% and fucking rig the game.
95. Oh no!
Dane accidentally selected 95%.
I guess that's my fault for.
You can't go. You can't go much higher because there's less than 15% for 100.
It's unanimous again.
Adam picked a lower. Everybody else picked much lower. It's 7%.
And of course, these 7%
you should have went on the other side.
I was tempted to put 1%. But...
88. You should have done that. 88% difference. 1,000 points to Adam. 2,000 to me, Ricardo, and Michelle. Time for the final round.
It's time for the final round.
You see what I was doing, huh?
Determine the most popular answers to this question.
All right. Yep. Survey determined the most popular answer to the what mortal sin do people most commonly confess they're guilty of? The choices: sloth, lust, envy, lying, pride, adultery, gluttony, all of them, or greed. Top three answers. Select your top three answers one at a time. So your number one answer, your number two answer, and your number three answer.
It's like playing tic-tac-toe.
Okay, Ricardo is selecting his. Alright, everybody's in.
Alright, let's see what everyone picked.
One vote for lust, two for envy, two for lying, two for pride, two for adultery, three for gluttony, one for all of them, and two for greed. Alright. The top three most popular answers. 17% gluttony, lust 18%, and the number one answer for 21% is sloth, which no one picked. 21%.
That sounds really backwards.
And the winner is...
The final scores. The winner of this game... is me! I've dethroned Ricardo!
Oh, shit.
But then again, I look like Ricardo, so technically he still wins.
Oh, my God. Great job. That was a disaster for me.
Well, tell you what we're going to do now. We're going to go back to Trivia Murder Party. So more of that after this. I just wanted to what's that?
I should actually get to bed. It's midnight. I have to be up at 6:30 in the morning tomorrow to get ready for work.
Ooh. That's
not good. Oh, indeed.
Well, it's because everyone has to be into work for 8, which means that it's a fight to get to the bathroom first.
Shit, I hit the wrong game. Hold on. I'm trying to play Quiplash,
too. I still can't believe that t-shirt game, how the game draws so eloquently. That's not even fair.
Yeah. Alright, more Trivia Murder Party coming up. The room code.
So,
are you taking off?
If you ever decide to play that again... Yeah, I'm taking off. If you ever decide to play that again, you should make it a house rule that if someone doesn't get their drugs in time, and you see a very obviously well-done draw, and you don't pick it...
Mm-hmm. We'll do that. In the meantime, thank you, Michelle, for being on.
Thank you guys for having me.
Twas a pleasure. Have a good night, Michelle. I've dropped the link for the Discord in the chat room for Ricardo, so he can join us. I gotta get in first. Hold on.
Good night, guys.
Night, Michelle.
Bye.
I'm Bob Saget now.
Oh, okay.
There's Rhythmix. Alright, HPXY. Yeah, I'm not gonna bother with hiding it at this point.
Hello, Ricardo, are you listening to me?
Trying to get in.
Hi, this meal.
Ah, that stupid thing. Poop on a chapstick.
Spooky Cardo. There's only 4 of us.
Well,
yes.
Is MVGDead?
All right, yeah, there is only 4 of us, so let's do this.
Alright.
Four of us. It's Dane, Adam, myself, and Ricardo.
Hey, Ricardo.
Yes, Dane?
Did you know that I think you're a very nice person?
Well, that's okay.
I was waiting for you to go, what?
What a twist.
What a tweet.
Welcome to Trivia Night. I see you've chosen to skip the tutorial I spent 3 days working on, but hey, you're impatient, and it's all about you, isn't it?
Alright, here we go. This will be interesting since there's only 4 of us. Question 1.
Okay, first question.
Here we go.
Personally, I don't like games that shun violence, but...
Slashing is a penalty in what sport? Football, hockey, baseball, soccer.
Use your device.
This is something that I think everybody's gonna get.
Yeah. I feel like everybody's gonna get that. It's hockey.
And the correct answer is...
I mean, that's no doubt about that.
You can slash on any other sport.
Everybody got it right.
Too easy.
See?
Let's try another one.
Who has a dog named Fuzz? Charlie Brown, Beetle Bailey, Kathy, or Ziggy?
Yeah. Hot Fuzz.
If you think Fuzz the dog is hot, I don't know. There's no help for you.
Oh, I picked the wrong one.
This one?
It's Ziggy. Dane and Adam missed it. They're going to the killing floor.
Well,
alright. Killing floor.
Killing floor.
Your game of choice of this time is...
Let's test your memory.
Patterns. Alright, green knife, blue knife, blue knife, blue gun. It's an easy pattern to remember.
Okay, you've had enough time. Is it distracting if I start yelling things out? Fish. Knife. Glasses. Ziggy.
From left to right. What was the order of weapons from left to right?
Oh.
And winning is its own. Only Dane and Adam are playing. By the way. So,
good luck. Well, son of a gun.
I got distracted.
I was gonna say, what if we both get it all right? Will we both live or will we both die?
You probably both live. That's knife, gun. Adam missed horribly. There was no hammer anywhere in there. Dane got it all right, so Adam.
That's why.
Adam gets. Distractions can occur in the field, soldier. That's why you died. Alright, me and Ricardo in the lead, Dane's in third, and Adam's in last. Mostly about the killing. But anything could happen. Let's get on to question two. Question three.
Alright, next question.
What cargo is picked up in Smokey and the Bandit? Is it sneakers, beer, chickens, or cigarettes?
What could it be? I don't know.
The correct answer is beer.
Oh.
Now me and Ricardo go into the killing floor.
My dad used to like smoking a bit. That's how I knew.
They got too many TV sequels.
Welcome back to the killing floor.
Me and Ricardo are playing.
Let's play the finger cutting game.
Fingers.
Just choose one of the colors.
No, fingers, no.
My dog could do it, but he doesn't have fingers.
Your fault.
Balls.
Think happy. Remember, the donation of your finger is taxed.
Let's see what happens.
I cut off the fourth finger. Ricardo cut off the second. Those are the answers that won't appear for us anymore.
Now Ricardo can't put people off.
Here's that scoreboard again.
Dane's in the lead. Adam's in second. Me and Ricardo in last.
Hey, Ricardo, are you flipping me off?
I actually have to get up for a second. I actually have to leave the computer for a second, so I'll be right back. But the game is going to continue.
Okay. The next question. Question four.
Which of the following is a Bruce Lee movie?
Waiting.
Loading.
Loading, loading, loading. Which of the following is a Bruce Lee movie? Kiss of Death, Angel of Death, Game of Death, or Faces of Death?
I'm so glad I know this one.
Who's
get up here.
This one.
It's the one with the basketball player. Only
you. Sure. Prepare for your punishment. The Game of Death is the right answer. And... oh, what was that? John, Mike's going to the killing floor. Hopefully he gets back in time. Need everyone's help. And he's going to be playing... all over my favorite piece of art. He's playing Memory.
Ooh.
I think everybody... we're all playing this. So everybody study the screen. Oh, I'm never going to get this.
Alright, that's enough time. It's been like 30 seconds since the last time I checked, so let's see what's happening on Instagram.
Memories.
Memories. That's get to at least 11, or it looks terrible.
Memories.
I am literally dying. That's it. I didn't want to do this, but I'm gonna like my own post. I just have to. All right, time to move on. Reproduce the pattern on your device by tapping on all the spaces that were red. Then press submit when you're done. If anyone does better than you, I will be testy.
I fucked it up.
Me too.
Here's that art again. And here's what.
Fortunately, if Mike doesn't come back, he's going to die by default, so let's see what happens.
Let's see if that's enough. I knew someone would rise to the challenge.
Oh, Mike is actually here. He has 40%.
Let's see. Holy shit! Ozzy Adam got 100%. That means Mike dies.
Same old story.
Okay, so right now the standings are as follows.
I've got more questions.
I'm in first. Ozzy Adam is in second. Ricardo's in third, and Mike's in first. Next question. Question 5. Who's Adele's baby daddy, and he better not hurt her? Chitwell, Ojafor, Simon Konecki, Henry Cavill, or Tom Hiddleston?
And the correct answer is...
The answer is... We'll find out in when the timer runs out.
Retreat.
Oh, there we go. Simon Konecki. Ricardo got it wrong.
Oh, good. It's the always the loser wheel.
And Ricardo's going to be playing.
No.
Uh-oh. It's the loser wheel. Oh, nice knowing you, Ricardo.
Speed it up.
Maybe Ricardo will get lucky.
I think he sees that one coming.
He gets... Oh! He almost got life! Oh, he was so close! Fortunately, Ricardo, you died, but I think that's the closest I've ever seen anybody get the sliver of life.
Almost there.
One more tick.
So I'm in a coma.
Well, looks like I'm the only one left alive.
Here's your first.
So I'm gonna have to run for my life.
I got fucked. Ben and Jerry's flavors, chocolate therapy, nuts to you, a swirl of difference. Everybody's playing now, by the way.
You missed it. Ricardo almost got life in the death.
Let's see the right answers.
Damn. I got fucked because I got pulled away and then the patterns game came up. Like, that sucks.
For every right answer.
I'm definitely going to want to play another one after that. By the way, nuts to you was the only answer there that was right. Chemical element, steel, magnesium, chemical sodium. Elements.
I felt, yeah. You actually got pulled away and apparently you got 40%.
Magnesium and sodium is the correct answers there. Yeah, I just randomly tapped my fingers on the thing. Like, there's nothing I could do. Star Trek film titles. The search for Spock, Generations, Nemesis. I mean, I'll be disappointed in all of you if you don't get this.
We as a geek culture
know. You all know that all of them are correct.
Shit.
Oh.
Generations was the Kirk and Picard meeting Star Trek movie, yeah. Ricardo.
It's different than Spock.
And Nemesis was the Borg one.
Yes. Rodgers and Hammerstein musicals. The Sound of Music, West Side Story, Oklahoma.
Ugh. I don't know what musicals.
Dane will know.
As a theater major, I know this.
Yeah. That's why I know he knows, because I know he's a theater major. Sound of Music in Oklahoma.
West Side Story was Sondheim.
Damn it.
Actually, I believe that was Candor and Ed.
Oh, looks like Dane's probably going to run away with this one. Birthstones, Ruby, Fusite, Opal.
Opal.
And yes, it's Fusite, not Fucksite. I don't know what a Fucksite is.
That's where you go with prostitutes.
Ruby and Opal is correct.
Opal. Ozzy Adams actually on my tail.
Yeah, I don't think it's gonna happen though.
Here's another one.
Legumes, beets, peanuts, sesame seeds.
Mm-hmm.
Was everybody in? Okay, good. Peanuts is the only correct answer. Dane wins.
I was actually commentating one.
I appreciate that. Yeah, we're playing again because I feel like I got fucked because of that patterns game coming up.
It's
I don't know if it would have made any kind of difference or anything, but yeah. There were two audience members?
I guess.
Nice.
Who else was in the audience?
I don't know.
Maybe, yeah.
Well, I guess we can find out. There's a way to find out, I suppose. By doing a new room code.
Is Mark in the chat?
No, only Ricardo's in the chat at the moment.
Yep.
Interesting.
It's ghosts.
ZWPE is the room code. ZWPE. I'm in there, so go ahead.
Hurry up. Yeah, got it.
Spooky, scary skeletons.
Spooky, scary skeletons. I'm sucking on my what?
There's something on my wall.
Ah! There's a guy named Keiko Bud. Don't know who that is.
I'm a little concerned.
Why?
Who could it be?
Because I hate when there's a person that we don't know who it is.
Yeah, I'm aware of that.
Maybe it's Robert Downey Jr.
I'm loading up Beam Pro to see if there's somebody in the chat on Beam Pro that Beam. I don't know about.
Keiko Bud, reveal yourself.
He is in the. There is somebody in the.
Identify yourself.
Mystery guest. Mystery guest.
And who's Chris? Somebody named Chris just joined in the game. Don't know who.
Oh, I just saw that. Yeah, I don't know who Chris is either. I know several people named Chris. So I don't know who it could be.
I hope it's not Chris's bro.
Two mystery people. That's
mysterious.
Damn this muff.
Alright. X out of that, and I'm going to go ahead and hit start record. Alright, let's do this. Five-person game with myself, Adam, Dane, Ricardo, and two people from the audience, Keiko Bud and Chris.
It's a six-person game.
Yeah, six-person game. That's what I meant.
Go away, moth.
No!
There's
a moth in here.
Are these Jackbox ringers?
I don't know. We're about to find out. Question one.
Let's see how schmott they
are.
How cool are Japanese toilets? Sort of cool, pretty cool, really cool, or the coolest?
Huh? Wait a minute.
Oh my god, that's the best question ever.
I feel like there's cool some hidden. I feel like there's some sort of hidden meaning here.
Yeah,
I'm thinking. Yeah.
Trying to think.
Too cool for school.
I'm just. I don't know.
I don't know.
The correct answer is the coolest.
Who got it right?
Adam and Keiko Bud got it wrong. They're going to the killing floor.
Well. I don't even know what's going on.
I don't even know about that question. That was weird. cool Japanese toilets. Toiretsu.
Toiretsu.
Adam and Keiko Bud, you're playing words. You're going to get a grid of letters on your device. Use those letters to spell the longest word you can before time runs out. The person with the shortest word will be punished. By death, that is. The letters do not have to be connected. Just spell with what you got. It's only Adam and Keiko Bud are playing, by the way, so the rest of us can lay out for a second. Good stuff. I'm looking at these letters, and I'm trying to figure out if there's anything I could spell with these. Damn.
I wonder what Keiko Bud what you came up with.
Adam has spelled the word Reggie. Keiko Bud spelled track.
Probably should have mentioned you have to enter actual words.
There's a name.
Track is a Reggie is not a word. This is gonna hurt. So Adam dies.
Damn you, Archie!
You have to enter actual words, not proper nouns. Proper nouns do not count. Adam dies. Keiko Bud lives because he actually wrote a word.
He lives. He lives.
Nice job, Keiko Bud.
I'll never read Archie comics again. So far,
it's real early. I'm sure they'll sleep. Okay.
Yeah, I'm sure they'll sleep fine, knowing that. Question number two, ladies and gentlemen, is...
Number dos.
According to LL Cool J, what did his mama say?
Oh, that is so...
There'd be days like this, to knock you out, turn off the lights, or to act like a gentleman.
It's literally in the song title.
Gee, I wonder what... It's not like I've seen that movie starring Michael Che.
What do you think, you're better than me?
Hey, you think you're better than me? You think you're better than all of us? You think you're better than my vagina? You think you're better? The correct answer is to knock you out, of course. Yes. Mama said knock you out. Keiko Bud and Ricardo, you're going to the killing floor.
The rest of you.
Oh, no.
Prepare for your punishment.
Ricardo, which one did you pick?
Turn off the lights.
That's one way of putting it. Ricardo and Keiko Bud, you are playing decisions. If one of you takes the money, the other one will be killed, but if both of you take the money, you both will be killed. And if nobody takes the money, then nobody dies. So that's how that works. Don't be a dick. Don't be a dick. Who was the dick? Keiko Bud's the dick. Ricardo's dead.
Yeah.
I knew we could trust that piece.
Never trust strangers. Never trust strangers.
Stranger danger.
You cannot depend on the kindness of strangers. I don't actually think you're a dick, Keiko Bud, but that was kind of a dick move. Then again, how could you discuss it with him? You're not even in our regular chat room. He's in the lead, by the way, Keiko Bud is.
Oh, my goodness.
Question three. The question is, which food is not in the onion family? Is it garlic, chives, fennel, or leeks?
Ooh. That's a tough one.
I'm with that one. I think that one's right. It's either that one or the other one. Well, I don't want to say my choices out loud and influence the answers. That would be stupid.
You mean that
either
one?
A, B, C, or D.
The correct answer is fennel. I was wrong on both counts anyway, so it don't matter. Me and Keiko Bud are going to the killing floor. There's a member of the audience.
Let's go someplace fun.
So like more and more people are joining us. Hi everybody. There's two people in the audience. Hi folks. Are you all on Beam right now? Is that what's going on?
We're going to play chalices.
Chalices is what we're going to play here.
Uh-huh.
The chalice of love.
All right. Everybody that is not me or Keiko Bud, put a chalice to put your poison in.
Let's see what happens.
While you're doing that, I'm going to go back to the Beam Pro chat and see what's going on.
We're the most popular in Beam.
Okie dokie.
Alright, me and Keiko Bud are now going to pick a chalice to drink from.
Who is the beaniest bean?
I keep thinking I should get a set of matching chalices, but each of these tells a unique. Good.
good to the last drop.
Oh, there are people there. Hi, the chrysanthemum. He's probably Chris. Oh. How you guys doing?
Yeah. Are they speaking?
2, 4, and 6 are the poisonous chalices. Keiko Bud dies. I'm sorry, Keiko Bud. Okay, I'm gonna pop out. I'm gonna pop out the chat, so the Beam Pro chat, so that I can keep up with these guys.
Are they saying anything or?
Yeah, they've been saying a few things. For those of you in the Beam Pro chat, if you'd like, you can join us on our main chat over at cstvlive.tk. That is where our main stream and chat is located. You don't have to, it's optional. I now have you guys up in a separate window, so that's fine. Doesn't really matter too much. And to the two of you in the audience who are just joining us, thank you for joining us. Hell, if we're still getting a lot of people watching this, we'll keep playing for a little bit.
Me, Mike, and Chris are the only ones left alive.
Yes. Me, Dane, and Chris are the only ones left alive. In the game of Operation, what object is located in the knee?
Aha!
Slice of bread, pail of water, small horse, or pencil? It's literally in the commercial song.
I was going to say, it's in the song.
It's in the song in the commercial.
Don't remember?
If you get this wrong, you're dead to me.
Trying to think.
Time to find out. Who said? This one?
Pail of water. Water on the knee, $1,000 fee.
Operation.
Only ghosts got it wrong, so that we move on. Question 5. Bleecker Street is part of what famous neighborhood? Is the answer the West End, Beverly Hills, Greenwich Village, or the French Quarter? I don't know this one, unfortunately.
Me neither.
I think I know who's laughing.
If Dane is laughing, then that gives away the answer.
Yeah.
Damn it.
I never do that if there's a question involving Australia.
And the correct answer is...
Greenwich Village. Myself and Chris got it wrong. We're going to the killing floor.
I think it's time for some senseless fire.
Chris and I are going to play Arena. Attack someone, defend yourself, or you can grab the money. But you must choose one now. Attack, defend, grab the money.
Who's going to be the dick?
It's harder to be a dick in this one, though, because there's three choices.
Well, that's true.
Alright. What you gonna do, Chris?
What you gonna do when they sit on you?
What you gonna do when I sit on you? Big butts, big butts. Chris and I chose to both defend.
Uh-oh.
No geese.
You defended yourself, even though no one had. I think that means you both get 86.
Yeah, since both Chris and I chose to defend ourselves, we both die.
And then they die.
And he was dead.
Well, unless it's been hacked again. Thanks a lot.
Well, there's an actual website that's triviamurderpartyrules.blogspot.com. Somebody see if that's an actual website, please.
Hopeless when that happens, but you know what are you gonna do? There are just bad people in this world.
In any event. I think we're down to one left alive. Yeah, Dane's the only one left alive.
Only one of you is still alive. You know so, what that means.
Alright, let's do this.
It won't be easy to escape with your body.
Dane, it's time to run for your life. Everybody's in, let's do this.
Here's your first category.
Woodwind instruments. French horn, euphonium, melodica. Instruments.
Tap on each answer that fits, then press submit.
For those of you who are just now playing the game, you can pick multiple answers if they fit the category. You can Or no answers if none of them fit the category. So just keep that in mind. And only ghosts get the third answer. Chris says, rest in peace.
Today, kiddo. Amen.
Amen. Yeah, I have, I've decided to, yeah, I've got the Beam chat open side by side with our chat, so I'm keeping an eye on both of them. I don't think we've had this many people in the actual Beam chat before, so that's good.
I almost picked one until I realized,
until yeah. You realized, durr, no. Time's up. The correct answer is just Melodica is the only one there.
Ah, yeah.
That's Euphonium. Euphonium is a woodwind. So that's wrong.
Think about it. That must be. Oh, wrong kind of woodwind. That's Wynwood, anyway. Las Vegas casinos, Trump Wizards, Treasure Island.
Never been to Vegas. So I don't know.
I've never been to Vegas, but I'm pretty sure about one of these at least.
Las Vegas.
Decisions. Viva Las Vegas.
Viva Las Vegas. Girl.
Thank you very much.
Why does your Elvis sound like Jabba the Hutt?
Thank you very much, you wonderful.
Too much.
I should say Andre the Jabba.
Treasure Island is the only correct answer there.
No.
Give me a sandwich.
There's a Trump casino in... What the hell's going on with this goddamn news?
Countries containing the Alps. France, the Netherlands, Italy. Oh, man. I don't think that one has it, so...
Thank you very much.
Adam, just don't. I don't know what you're trying to do, but it's not an Elvis Presley. Unless that's Elvis right before he died on the toilet.
Oh,
thank you very much. Oh, thank you very much. Fat, bloated Elvis.
Nixon! Nixon!
France and Italy are correct. Kickle Butts are catching up. You better be careful there, Dan. Next category.
Okay.
Letters in the Greek alphabet. Gamma, Beta, Chi.
Jeez. Really?
It's not like we just walk around with a copy of the Greek alphabet in our pockets all day, Adam. I don't think, I'm not boned up on the Greek alphabet. It doesn't matter if you've seen Animal House. You only get to know, four of the letters in that anyway. Because one of them is Lambda, Lambda, Lambda. Gamma and Beta, correct.
I felt the thigh.
I get it. You did well.
And it opened up your eyes? You felt the thighs?
Sure.
Ace of Ace? Bands with three members. Wilson Phillips, Run DMC, Dixie Chicks.
Chicks with dicks. What?
Whoa.
Okay.
Is there going to be more rounds after this, or is this the last one? Yeah, we'll play another one. I don't have a problem with that.
Who's asking?
Chris in the Beam chat is asking that. Is there going to be more rounds after this, or is this the last one? No, I was gonna end, but, we got... friggin' people jumping in the Beam chat, so I can't in good conscience end it when we still got plenty of people to play the game, so yeah, no, we'll play another round. All three are correct, by the way. Phil some selves, DNC, and Dixie Chicks. All three members.
Phillips?
Yeah. Two of the members are named Phillips, and then there's Carney Wilson.
Yes.
Or maybe I got that the other way around. Chewing gum brands, Big Red Fruit Stripe, Scrubbing Bubbles. I would totally not chew one of these.
If you're chewing one of them, there's a big problem.
There's a big problem if you're chewing one of these.
Scrubbing bubbles.
Fucking bottles!
Scrubbing bottles?
Ew! Do you like bubbles?
Yeah, obviously big red and fruit stripe are the answers. Yeah, don't chew scrubbing bubbles. Those are poisonous. Those are meant for your bathroom.
Bathroom cleaning.
Wait, everybody got all of those. That's amazing. Dane's like a space from being out the door. Keiko Bud's right behind him. Characters in a Star Wars A New Hope. Lando Calrissian, Boba Fett, R2-D2.
That's a funny one. I bet people who only seen the original edition of the trilogy will go,
but
he wasn't in it.
I wonder what version of Star Wars A New Hope they're going by here, though.
Yeah,
exactly.
Because this could be like a dick question. Not like a dick question, but a dick question. You know what the fuck I mean.
Yeah.
I don't even know what I mean.
I don't know what you mean.
R2-D2 is the only answer. Yeah, I think officially Lando and Boba Fett didn't appear till the second movie or the fifth episode.
And if you're going by special edition, Boba Fett on the first? On that first one.
Apparently not, though, on this one. Dane wins. Dane won, by the way. Chris says, it's been so long since I've seen this. Yeah, I have not watched... I have not watched the first Star Wars movie in a long time.
I'm going to sit out this next one because I need to do a couple of things before I go to bed.
Okay.
But I will hang on the Zikal.
All right, I'm going to open a new room for Trivia Murder Party, and I'll just send out the room code in just a moment.
Ebola.
Ebola.
Ebola. No more kissing.
Bola, bola, bola.
Hey y'all.
Just want to say a special howdy ho to all of our friends in the Beam Pro chat who joined us tonight. Thank you guys.
Why are you saying?
Our official chat room is at cstvlive.tk. It's where we try to keep everybody. I'm not gonna tell you not to be in the Beam Pro chat. That would be stupid. But you can at least consider joining us. The room code is RRYN. I'm not going to bother hiding it. RRYN.
Okay, I've been gone for a second. What's the code?
RRYN.
Alright.
I went ahead and dropped it in the Beam chat for them.
Beam!
Okay. Looks like we might have a 7-person game here if things work out. Maybe even an 8-person game.
Oh, shit.
Let me look at the... Yeah, there's enough people... There's enough viewers in the Beam chat right now. We can end up having a full game if things work out. Well, that's right, because Dane's not playing this. So it'll still only be like a 7-person game, but it could have potentially been a full game. That would have been amazing. Not... Doesn't matter, though. Is everybody in? Is everybody in the Beam chat in?
Beam.
I see a few people. I see Bun Bun's in there now.
Bun Bun?
Yeah, Bun Bun 74. Hi, Bun Bun. Chris is back in there. Keiko Bud's back in there. Yeah, the reason I like paused for a second when I saw that name, Chris, is because I know like 7 Chris's. So like it could have been any one of those people, but I'm glad to have you.
So much
Chris. Hey, gamer. Hey. Don't bully me. Don't bully me, says Bun Bun. Don't worry.
Who's bullying? Who's bullying?
Nobody's bullying anybody.
Who said don't bully? From Confusion.
Okay, I guess everybody's in, so I will hit start record on my end, and... Hello, let's do this. I know like 8 of us too. Yeah, it's true. My name and your name are the most popular names in the world, apparently.
Are you telling me Aloysius is not a popular name?
Not as I recall. How do I play? Okay, you're going to be asked a trivia question. If you get it right, cool. If you get it wrong, you go to the killing floor to play for your life. If you fail the minigame, you die. Okay. Death is not the end. If you can still win as a ghost, no, and that's all you need to know for now.
Except in this game. second place dies in this game.
Bum, bum, bum.
What's the second highest peak in the world? The correct answer is either Mount Kilimanjaro, Mount Everest, K2, or the Matterhorn.
Actually, the second highest peak is mine. That's a lot.
Oh, I'm torn between two answers here.
Torn between two answers?
Torn between two lovers. The answer is K2. Yes! I got it right.
Yes.
Everybody got it right. Nicely done, everybody. Good job.
By the way, the trivia part murder party block spot is does not exist.
Okay. Question two. I don't know what that means. Which gas is laughing gas exactly? Is it nitrous oxide, nitrous monoxide, nitrous sulfide, or nitrous dioxide?
Because if you remember in the last game, the guy made the joke about, oh, go visit trivia murder party rules at block spot.
I've seen one as Fresh Prince.
It is a real site?
It is not a real site.
Not a real site. Okay. Thank you. I appreciate that.
Never comes.
No screen.
It's pictures of dicks with dicks in them.
Wow. That's a horrible trick.
Yes.
Time is up. The correct answer is nitrous oxide. Damn it. I missed it. Me, Keiko Bud, and Chris go to the killing floor.
Come with me.
Come on, beam people, step it up.
Isn't loading for me. I don't know why. It's working fine on my end. I'm sorry.
Yeah.
Me, Keiko Bud, and Chris are playing Greed.
That's weird. Don't be a dick. Most don't be a dick.
Take the most or the least money, and you will be punished.
I'm gonna order something from Domino's.
Ooh, la-di-da, Mr. Domino's man. What, you think you're better than me?
No, I'm hungry. That's why.
Oh, okay.
Hungry for power.
Alright, take the most or the least money and you will be punished. Alright.
It's a good thing there's... good thing there isn't, like, only two people playing, because then nobody would win.
Look, I know money issues can be scary, but you just have to pick something.
Alright, everybody got in. Little piggies took. I put 553, Keiko Bud put 502, Chris put 500, me and Chris die.
And then they die.
Damn, we all got really close though. We were all within like $50 of each other. Damn it. Damn it, damn it, damn it. R.I.P. the dream, yeah. Indeed. All right.
Here's everybody's scores. It's a good way to compare yourself to others.
Right now in the lead, Ricardo, Adam, and Bun Bun are the three-way tie for the lead right now.
I'll do it later.
Next up is question three. Let's do this. One. Question three is...
I have such a sweet tooth. Well, actually, I have a whole bag of them. I dip them in sugar and...
I have a sweet tooth, a whole bag of them. That's wonderful. Which of the following fruits is not found in a miniature form in miniature form in a box of Runtz candy?
Oh shit, too specific.
Banana, lemon, green apple, strawberry.
Lemon.
The correct answer is lemon. Ah.
Oh, shit.
Alright. This is the end for me, says Bun Bun. God rest my soul. Bun Bun goes to killing floor. Well, if you don't get loser's wheel, you'll probably survive, honestly. Let's hope for fingers, actually, because that's probably the one where you're least likely to die.
Oh, hell, son.
You're playing. Oh, okay. Math. And this is everybody's playing. Answer as many math questions as you can before time runs out. Everybody else is playing too, and if anybody else does better than you, you will die. Simple as that. On your mark, get set, math.
Let's go. Math.
Math your balls off.
Math your balls off. Ah, fuck me.
Don't get crunched by the numbers. You're approaching the math finish line.
Time is up. Bun Bun got 9 correct. Three people did better than that, so I am sorry, Bun Bun, but you have died.
Oh, he did.
Remember, though, death is not the end. You can still continue playing and possibly win the game. So don't count yourself out. Don't forget me. We won't.
What's his name again?
Bun Bun. Bun Bun 74.
Okay.
Carter's in the lead, Adam's in second, Kekobud's in third. Question 4 is upcoming. And that question is, what state does the Netflix documentary Making a Murderer take place in?
Oh, shit. I just watched that.
North Dakota, Wisconsin, Minnesota, or Michigan? Excuse me, I'm a grill gamers. I apologize.
Say what?
A Bun Bun is female. I have been referring to Bun Bun as he. I apologize. I will refer to you as she from this point forward.
Well, Bun Bun, you should probably have let us know that 20 minutes ago.
No biggie. Wisconsin is the correct answer.
Fuck.
Ricardo goes to the killing floor. Hey, Ricardo, you're going to play dice.
I'll go first.
Oh.
It's time for Easily Outraged Ricardo. Hey, Ricardo, did you know that the murderer rolled a 10? And that Kaiko Bun is deciding whether you're going to roll higher or lower to live?
You can make it as hard or as easy as you want.
No. How could this happen to me?
Alright, Keiko Bun is really cruel and decided you have to roll lower than 10 to live. So, Ricardo, roll your dice.
Roll lower than me or you're not.
Ricardo, I'm afraid you rolled a 14.
Oh no.
Have a nice death. Bun Bun and I are pals. Me and Chris are pals.
Good
to hear.
I see.
Well, I'm glad we could bring people together playing a game about killing people for answering trivia questions.
Trivia.
Adam and Keiko Butter still left alive. Mother Teresa's full title was Blessed Mother Teresa of...
The streets
of my anus.
Calcutta, Mumbai, New Delhi, or Bombay?
Shamal Ding Dong.
What?
My mom is so biblical that I know this answer.
College of Streets.
Who picked this?
Calcutta is the answer. I didn't know either, actually, I guessed.
Calcutta?
Only ghosts got it wrong, so we're just gonna move on. Question number 6. Let's do it.
Next question.
What is Germany's minimum legal drinking age?
1.
13, 13, 16, 18, or 20. If only our Austrian friend was here, he would probably know.
Yeah.
Where the hell is Steve Don? Or whatever his name is. You tell him, Steve Dave. 16 is the correct answer, by the way.
Yes.
Again, all the remaining alive contestants got it right, so we're going to continue. No, we're not, actually. Keiko Bud and Adam, even though you got that right, you're still going to go to the killing floor because we need to wrap this round up, apparently. Worst answer.
What's the funniest word?
Write down the answer to this. Your best answer to this. What's the funniest word? Oh, man, there's so many good answers for this. It's unfortunate that, like, only one of the people doing this minigame would know some funny words that are inside jokes from the mental cast.
Yeah.
Grand Dad.
So the words in question are either McCorkle or titties.
Hey. Wait a minute.
I know who wrote what, unfortunately.
It's kind of a...
Unless Keiko Bud knows our inside jokes. I don't know, though. This is kind of... I gotta go with that one, unfortunately. We're picking the worst answer, by the way. 3-1, Titties is the loser. So, Titties, Keiko Bud, sorry, man.
Don't worry.
It's not your fault. That is a inside joke from our podcast that we do on Tuesday nights live. So, that's not your fault for not knowing that.
It's also Chelsea's safe word.
It is Chelsea's safe word, yes. That's true.
Oh, look. Only one player left.
Adam is the sole remaining player. Adam Benarchik, it's time for you to run for your life.
Better run.
This is gonna suck.
Here's your first category.
All right. First up, Simpsons characters voiced by Hank Azaria. Anything. Remember, chat. Anything that fits that category, you select it and hit submit. If nothing fits that category, just hit submit. Everything could possibly fit the category.
Yeah.
I legitimately forgot which characters he voices.
And only ghosts get that last answer, by the way. So Adam only has two to work with, while the rest of us have three answers to work with. By the way. Only Disco Stew was voiced by Hank Azaria out of those three.
For every right answer.
Yeah, I messed up on that one. Alright, next up, Shades of Purple, Lilac, Violet, Lavender.
Shades of Purple.
All three are correct. Pretty sure most of you knew that. Yeah, most of you did know that. Nicely done. Mammals, hedgehog, platypus, mole. I may have fucked up on this one.
Shit. Now I remember.
All three are correct. Yeah, I did screw up. Keiko Bud is like two spaces behind Adam, so...
Where's Perry?
Beware of the darkness.
Where's Perry? He's lead singer of Jane's Addiction. Shellfish.
Oh, the platypus.
Shellfish, tilapia, scallops, prawns. Come on, don't be shellfish. Don't be cruel to a heart that's true. Don't want no other love. Scallops and prawns are correct. Ooh, Keiko Bud's like a space behind Adam. Be careful, Adam. To be fair, a lot of people aren't very far behind. Hawaiian Islands, Burkina Faso, Lanai, Kahalawe.
Geography?
Lanai and Kahulawe are correct. Keiko Bud has taken over Adam and regained his body.
What a crazy game, am I right?
But Adam's a space behind, Ricardo's a couple behind. Chuck Norris films, Dirty Harry, Sidekicks, and Eye for an Eye. I'm almost certain about one of these. In fact, I'm 100% sure about one of these.
Yeah, because we all imagined that.
Really good with these pronunciations. Thank you. Sidekicks and Eye for an Eye are the correct answers. Oh, God. Keiko is about out the door.
Here comes the next question.
So close. Godzilla opponents. Ghidorah, Megalon, Unagi.
Unagi!
Unagi! Is that what was gonna set on France?
Oh no.
Ghidra and Megalon are correct answers.
There you go.
Keiko Bud is the winner. Congratulations.
Crap.
He would have had to miss the entire question for anybody to overtake him, unfortunately. So that's what happened.
Oh.
Congratulations, Keiko Bud. You won the game. Nicely done.
Congratulations.
I knew that one, too, though. Yeah, the people in the chat are saying this. There's one thing I know. It's Godzilla opponents. It's true. Like, Unagi is literally eel, so that's not a Godzilla opponent. So it had to be the other two. I knew the other two, Megalon and Ghidorah. I have a friend who's really into Godzilla, so, like, I would be ashamed if I didn't get that right.
Godzilla.
Guys, thank you. I wish I could play another game with you, but it's almost 1 a.m., and that's about time for us to wrap up MVG Live for the night. Guys, in the Beam Chat, don't hesitate to come back. We do this every Wednesday night at 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific. Whatever time that is in your area, that's usually like what, about like, I don't know, I'd have to look it up for other areas of the world, but like it's 10 Eastern, 7 Pacific in the US and Canada. Every Wednesday we do this. We also do Mentalcast every Tuesday night, same time. We do You Can't Be Serious on certain Saturday nights at 10 o'clock as well. Keep an eye on Facebook, facebook.com/MVGLive. We do have future events planned. Next Wednesday, we will be finishing Where in the USA is Carmen Sandiego. 2 weeks from tonight, we start Donkey Kong Country 3 on SNES. 3 weeks from tonight, we do Autumn Altercation, which will be a pay-per-view simulation featuring SmackDown Here Comes the Pain. 4 weeks from tonight, we're playing more Donkey Kong Country 3. 4 weeks and 1 day from tonight on Thanksgiving night, which is also my birthday, we're also playing DKC3. Thank you guys for joining us. Really appreciate it. You guys are awesome. Keep coming back. Have a good night, everyone.
Good night.
Good night.